Rundle Mall manager Andrew White says they're catering to everything a shopper needs.
And we're going to have major discounts across all retail categories. A lot of activity. We have our Rundle Mall concierge and bag drop service. You can come in, do your shopping, drop your bag, start drinking the pit stop bar in the Baller Place canopy, and grab a bargain.
And it might be a good time to buy some new underwear. Yes, new data shows Australians aren't getting new knickers and jocks. The US market
really
the Australian market has been very difficult with sales plunging in the past year. Now turning to FIVEAA sport.
Doors adding strength, safety and style to South Australian homes for over 40 years. Gliderol.com.au.
Here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Kendall. Oh, yeah. Lost to India by 2 wickets in their first men's T20 following the World Cup. Wicketkeeper Josh English.
Yeah, I agree. He seems really shy.
Well played, young man. What a moment that'll be for him. Class all around the wicket. Front foot, back foot.
Yeah, an amazing achievement that
I had right
thanks to Fox Sports. Now, English finished up making 110, but unfortunately, India chased down the target.
Good read at the start.
Spare.
You do. We got printed reads, and they
did not back up his best on-ground efforts in off-field celebrations following the World Cup. Well, qualifying begins today for the Adelaide 500 as the supercars hit the streets of Adelaide in what are expected to be very soggy conditions. Spaniard Josh Moscatel is the man to catch after the opening round of the Australian PGA Championship in Queensland. He finished his opening round at 8 under par and is just one shot clear of Minwoo Lee, who's sitting at 7 under par, while there are several Australians hot on the heels, including Lucas Herbert, who's back at 5 under. And tennis legends Novak Djokovic and Leighton Hewitt are calling for the Davis Cup finals to return to a home and away format. And that's the 5AA sport.
Now the 5AA forecast.
Stay cool. Service your aircon at Automasters. And keep cool with cool now, pay later options.
Showers easing in 22 today. Showers tomorrow, 20. Cloudy on Sunday, 21. And cloudy for Monday, 20. At the moment, 15. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Harvey Norman Black Friday sale starts today. Stores open until 9 tonight. Race in for one-day-only deals. Save $300 on the new Google Pixel 8, now $898. Save $750 on HP Pavilion i5 laptop, now $749. That's half price. Save $1,000 on HP Victus i7 gaming laptop, now $998. That's half price. Save $300 on MacBook Air M1, now $1,198. Hurry, one-day-only at Harvey Norman. Stores open until 9 tonight. Trading hours may vary.
As well as a sweet-looking camper, Austrac Campers can also hook you up with a competitive finance rate. So visit austraccampers.com.au for all the rates, terms, fees, charges and financial stuff.
Austrac Campers!
Footwear that's 20% off store wide.
But don't delay, this deal is on today only. So put your on your running shoes, get to Grundy's and upgrade them for a great price.
Grundy Shoes Black Friday sale available in store at Rundle Street, Adelaide, Jetty Road, Glenelg, and Ocean Street, Victor Harbour, or shop online 24/7 at grundyshoes.com.au.
For nearly 40 years, no one has done certified used cars quite like Steinborner Automotive. With dedicated yards including SA's best range of commercials loaded and ready to go, including SA's only dedicated small car and SUV centre, and SA's only large SUV and 4x4 centre suited for any lifestyle. Steinborner still also has the best range of Commodores from ZBs to the collectibles. View all late model used vehicles at steinborner.com.au. Steinborner Automotive. It's well worth the trip.
Breakfast on 5AA, David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
If you're living with a disability, injury or health condition and looking for work, visit maxima.com.au.
7 after 6, good morning to you. Welcome to Friday on 5AA Breakfast, broadcasting live this morning from about 15 metres away, I would suggest, from the start-finish line at the along Pitt Straight and the Velo Adelaide 500. There's a giant electronic TV screen behind us beaming images of South Australia and the race. There's giant empty grandstands that will be filled up over the course of the weekend. There's some, the old utility vehicle appearing on the track at the moment to just tidy things up, keep it dry. It's going to be a hive of activity down here over the course of the next couple of days, and it's just fascinating being here behind the scenes, seeing it all get prepared throughout the morning. We'll be talking a lot about the race today. Mark Warren will be on the program, the CEO of the SA Motorsport Board. He'll join us. One of us, and it ain't me, is going to be driving around the track in the course car, which is actually, you're just so close to everything. The race control vehicle is about 4 metres away from us, from where we're broadcasting as we speak this morning. It's going to be a good morning. We'll get you across all the things going on around Adelaide, Australia and the world as well. But David Penberthy, good morning to you very much. We are trackside in mind and body.
We certainly are, Will. This is easily the best setup we have ever had for an outside broadcast. We're in these beautiful sort of white, modernist-looking leather lounges. It's very...
It's got an Oprah Winfrey feel to
it. I know.
This,
I feel like
it?
I'm going to tell you my life story.
Yeah, you're going to jump up and down?
Yeah, I might go full Tom Cruise. What was the thing that made him jump up and down?
I think it was his love for Katie Holmes.
That didn't last long, though, did it?
No, they're not still together? I don't know. I don't keep up with celebrity guys.
Yeah, no, neither do I. But no, anyway, white couches aside, this is as good as it gets. And I've already, through my own sheer incompetence, had a pretty close look at the track this morning. On arriving at the Wakefield Street entrance to the car park to get in, I somehow managed to take a wrong turn, and to my surprise and then initially fear but then delight, I realised I was actually driving along the track.
That was one of the funniest moments in the history of this program. Sam Daddo here is producing the show with us, and Sam and I are sitting here, it's about 6:05, and we're wondering, where's David? Sam gets a phone call and says, oh, here he is, here's David. And he picks up the phone and says, so hang on, where are you? And I feel like, well, it's kind of confusing around here because it's a big area and you can get lost behind the grandstands. No, that wasn't why he was confused. He said, hang on, I can see you. And there, the opposite of herring along pit straight, is you.
In a Toyota Kluger.
In your Kluger.
Looking like some lost soccer mum. Itching trying to pick, pick your kids up.
The least spectacular thing that anyone will see.
I was doing about 20 kilometres an hour.
It was
I asked a guy.
You're the only bloke in the history of the Velo 500 that's gotten on pit straight on race day and said, I can't find a part.
So the guys were really nice at the entrance, which I think was the right entrance to use, Wakefield Street, to get into car park A where the media were parking here today. But he either said just go down before or after the second overpass. So I came down Wakefield Road and somehow I got past I think I misheard him. I should have gone before the second overpass and turned right to get into car park A, but I managed to get through this little sort of slip lane bit near the second overpass, and then I turned right and I was coming out like this big hairpin bend, and I thought, this actually feels like the track. And then I spoke to some garbo guy who was like setting up bins, and I said, have you got any idea where I am? And he said, yeah, I'm pretty sure you're on the track. And but yeah, then I just thought, well, I'll just go with it. I'll just lean into it.
Yeah.
And eventually I'll find a gap. about 12 minutes.
Yeah, okay. Did you get...
I was actually out there for almost that long.
Did you warm up in the second sector, or was it all pretty steady going the whole way?
I didn't want to get it too far above, you know, 30 k's.
Right.
Just in the wet.
Yeah, you didn't have your wets on.
You got an extra...
You shouldn't have put the slicks on this morning. That was your mistake.
But it was good because it was a bird's eye view of everything. And even though I was hands-free on the mobile to Sam saying, where the hell am I and how do I find the car park, it was a really good way to get a sense of how exciting it's going to be when it's actually all up and running.
You can watch along this morning on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream. We've graduated from the yesterday's phone on a stick. We've actually got a camera in here today, which is a device befitting the setup that we've got, because it is a magnificent place. If you're coming to the track today, we'd love to hear from you. 8223 00. You can text us on the Dutton's text line as well, or indeed if you want to talk about any of the things going on right around the world at the moment, we welcome you to do so. It is a Friday morning, which means we do have a meat tray to give away, thanks to Corinthian Meats, family-owned business. Peter the dad, Harry the son, support local, buy from local. We're asking you a car-inspired question this morning. Have you ever had a notable, beloved, or funny license plate? Notable, beloved, or funny license plate. For whatever reason, it could have been the formulation of letters and words meant something to you. It might have meant something inappropriate. It might have been something that you grew fond of for whatever reason. If you've ever had one, or maybe it was just a sequence of numbers that you consider lucky or particularly rare.
People pay so much for these things. Completely. Like if you get like a single digit number,
yeah,
they can cost like $100,000, can't they?
Oh, absolutely.
Even more.
Absolutely. When you bid on these things at auction.
I reckon they became a thing in about 1980, 85. Every now and then, speaking of motorsport, you see people around town with the old Grand Prix number plates.
Yeah.
Remember them?
Yeah, absolutely.
With the black and white flag.
But people often have, you know...
We bought a personalised number plate as a joke for my Uncle Bruce for his 40th, I think, and it was Burp, B-E-R-P, 40, because it was his nickname. He loved it. He had done his old green Magna.
So, of course, we're not exclusively talking about personalised this morning. We, you know, you might have had a sequence of numbers that ended up being something that you like. People often name their car after the number plate. It might be the Bob or the Birdie or wherever it might well be.
I always remember the number plate on Dad's Commodore, the buff-coloured tan Commodore L station wagon, and the reason I remember it is because the car just got driven into the ground, and in the end, when my sister bought the big block she was on up in Strathalbyn, the car was gifted to my brother-in-law Andy, who was driving it one day, and the fuel tank sort of fell off it on Ashbourne Road, and then that was sort of like the death knell of the car. So my sister, somehow they reattached the fuel tank, took it to a wrecker's yard in Christie's Beach, and my sister was just basically there saying, please take this car, I don't want any money. And this Darrow-looking bloke who at 8 o'clock in the morning was drinking from a six-pack of Cougar bourbon cans, called out and goes, you're giving that car away? And Bet goes, yeah, I am. He goes, well, I'll give you $20 for it. Bet goes, all right. So she sold Dad's car for $20.
Oh, wow.
Sure enough, 4 hours later, there's a ding-dong at Mum and Dad's place in Mitchell Park. There's a copper standing on the front door, and he says to Dad, are you Lloyd Penberthy, the registered owner of 1981 Commodore L registration SPM 367?
Mm.
And Dad goes, oh, no, I've actually got rid of that car. We sold it today. And the cop just laughs and says, well, it's just been used as a getaway car and a bank robbery. SPM 367.
There you go. That's a reason that could win you a meat tray. Was your car involved in a bank robbery? 8223 00 00. You can text us to on the Dutton's text line 0408 08 1395. Notable number plates. Fond, funny, or simply memorable. Let us know what they are and you could win yourself that meat tray by 9 o'clock this morning. We'll take a break and come back with news headlines very shortly.
Mawson Lakes Mazda's 2023 play clearance sale is on now. Discover amazing deals across the entire range, including free on-road costs on all cars. That's right, free on-road costs across the entire Mazda range. Hurry in to find your perfect model and colour. The sooner you get to the showroom, the better your chance of scoring your dream car. Mawson Lakes Mazda, just a short drive from the city, Salisbury Highway.
Fresh Tassie salmon fillets are full of omega-3 protein and much easier to grab than live salmon. Plus, they're now only $14.99 for a 4-pack at Aldi.
There's a bear in the store!
Every time. Aldi. Good. Different.
It's Black Friday this weekend at Cheapest Chips with fantastic deals to help you live cheaper. This Friday only, you can get a Blaupunkt 55-inch 4K Ultra HD HD TV with built-in Chromecast and Google Assist for only $499. You can save $200 on that one. They've also got the Pent Metal Shed for $249. You save $100 on that.
Then you can pick up a stick vacuum cleaner for just $99. And from Saturday to Monday only, that is, get 25% off all white goods. That's 25% off the Germanica tumble dryer and washing machine or the Germanica chest freezer. Great for storing all those Christmas leftovers.
So they also have 25% off all toys to get you sorted for Christmas and up to 50% off genuine Adidas men's shoes.
And there's many more amazing Black Friday weekend deals at Cheapest Chips. Grab their Black Friday catalogue or check it out online and live a life cheaper with Cheapest Chips.
Since 1982, our passionate teams at First National Real Estate have worked 10,400 days and around 582 million hours across Australia with one common goal, to always put you first. And we'll be here in Adelaide to help you on your journey to your happy place. Be it a tree change, a sea change, upsize, downsize, or finding that investment gem. First National Real Estate. We put you first. firstnational.com.au.
Hello, Frank Walker from National Tiles. The National Tiles Black Friday event ends midnight tonight. This is the biggest National Tiles online and in-store event of the year. Spend $4,000 and we'll only charge you $2,750. Or spend $2,000 and we'll only charge you $1,450. This National Tiles Black Friday event is absolutely massive. So go to nationaltiles.com.au now. But you'll have to be quick. This offer ends midnight tonight.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube.
Breakfast on 5AA, David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
Jobs, apprenticeships, traineeships and careers. Maxima can help. Learn more today at maxima.com.au.
18 minutes after 6, Rob on the Dutton's text line's got a comment on your pit straight jaunt this morning that wasn't part of the script. Rob says, David, did you get a chance to activate your DRS to overtake the bin guy? How'd you go?
What's DRS?
Drag reduction system. Oh, I think it's an F1 right. thing.
Have I got
it?
One of them?
Yeah,
right?
it's Formula 1.
I don't think
one.
They've got them in a Toyota Kluger.
I don't unless you got the real the big
all
extra
all I know
package.
Is that if you buy a slab of Cooper's Pale Ale at the pub and put it on the passenger seat, you need to clip the seatbelt in because otherwise it just goes ding, 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 ding. It's got that safety feature.
Stewie's got a Meat Tray Friday entry. Says, I accidentally got a personalised plate at work. I was allocated a new truck with the plate SB62GB. He says, SB, my initials, 6-2, the year of my birth, GB, I'm a pommy bastard. Thank you, Stewie. Appreciate that on the Dutton's text line, 0408-08-1395. We're just chatting with Sam Oakley down here at the Velo Adelaide 500 track. The Sunday corporate hospitality wise is all sold out, but you can still get tickets to come along today and indeed tomorrow. And in the process of watching some great racing action, you can sample the wares of our next guest. Shane Krebs is the Group Chief Executive at Gemma Group. Good morning to you, Sean.
Good morning, fellas. How are you?
We're good, Shane. Now, this must be bigger than Ben-Hur, like a massive military operation. Have you got any sense of, like, well, first in terms of actual people through the door, how many are you sort of catering for this weekend?
Well, across this weekend, probably, I couldn't even think of how many corporate facilities we have, but there's probably about 16,500 we'll do over the Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday.
16,500 people you've got to feed?
Yeah, all coming out of no less than 12 kitchens. on site.
So how many chefs are here?
Probably over 40.
Wow. Yeah. Right.
Yep.
Well, so 40 though, it still feels like unders for 16,000 people.
It's a hell of an operation, but you know, there's a lot of other additional staff on top of that. But yeah, 40 chefs to begin
so
with.
So when does the prep start?
That would have started Monday this week.
Right.
And it rolls, it's pretty much 24 hours. We sort of work into the night, and then there's, you know, when we're trying to sleep at night, there's a crew that come in and the little fairies come and deliver all the food to where it needs to be. So, yeah.
It's all crackerjack stuff as well, because it's a bit of a showcase for South Australia, this. We've got people flying in from all over the place.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there's obviously a lot of action on track, and that's their job. All the stuff off track is my job, and that's exactly right. It's just trying to provide, you know, an experience off the racetrack through dining and food and beverage and service. And
so are there different sort of levels of what you can get? Like, is there sort of, you know, if you just want the entry level, you know, pie pasty sausage roll sort of deal, right up to, you know, the pre-peeled king prawn with a mango coolie, that sort of gear?
Absolutely. There's definitely, you know, entry level and something that's accessible to everyone. And then, you know, then on some days, you know, it's right up there feeding the premier and you know,
right.
everybody else.
He's a man of simple taste. He'd be happy with the sausage roll.
Is this the biggest event you do in a year?
It's up there with one of the biggest. I also look after Formula One in Melbourne, and in terms of numbers, this is definitely up there.
Yeah, yep. Right.
Yep.
So you're based in Adelaide, or have you come here especially?
I work all around the country. I follow V8 supercars all around Australia, New Zealand.
Cool.
So this is the grand finale for us.
You're the chef to the supercars fan. Well, you could. Okay. Well, this is good because we can learn some things here. You can expunge some myths about, you know, the V8 fan and what their tastes are.
Oh, it's
what's is there a regular thing that makes the menu at every race meet around the country?
No, listen. I think it's, you know, for us it's very different state to state. It's regional basis, like you said. You know, it's trying to showcase. You know, obviously Adelaide has a lot. You know a lot of great food and wine. So, you know, what can we tap into? What can we tap into that we can get on scale?
Yeah.
And not feed for a couple of people, but you know, or feed for 16,000. So, you know, it's all, you know, it can be a bit tricky sometimes trying to, you know, get what we want for the sheer volume of people that we need.
And look, we're parochial and biased because we're based in Adelaide or an Adelaide radio station. But, you know, we can think of all the wonderful produce you've got to work with around here.
Mm.
How did this Gold Coast go?
How does Bathurst go?
It's going to be my next one. But at least Bathurst is racing royalty.
Listen, yeah, and well, that's right. But we are definitely spoiled for choice when it comes to, you know, what I deal with, and that's food and beverage. So, you know, it is a pleasure to come here and, you know, be able to tap into, you know, all the great things that we can.
So how did that start? That's an amazing... It's an amazing chef journey, I imagine, professionally. How did you end up getting into being on the supercar circuit?
Listen, as a company, we look after a lot of, you know, stadium venues and, you know, other fixed venues. And they just coincidentally happen to be involved with a lot of sporting, NRL and different things like that. And, yeah, I think supercars was a bit of a, you know, a natural progression or, you know, outside events. Like, we take care of a lot of tennis. At the moment, I'm doing the Brisbane PGA at the same time in Brisbane. So, yeah, so we've become relatively sport-focused. That's just something that's happened organically.
Yeah, but it's changed a lot, sport, hasn't it? Because people want to... they actually want something beyond sport, don't they? They really like getting into the sort of packages that are available this weekend.
Absolutely. Well, let's make no mistake, you know, people part with some good money to, you know, to be in these high-end facilities. And, you know, obviously, you guys are the best seat in the house. They looked after you.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
and the other good thing is you can park out the front, as I found out earlier.
Or get moved along very quickly. So, yeah, Pete, you're exactly right. It doesn't matter whether you're in a stadium or you're out at a site like this, the expectations change, you know, worlds apart from what it used to be. So,
yeah,
it's incredible.
And it's just, you know, and particularly when it rains, like, you know, there's no action on track. Like, what are people looking for? You know, what's going on inside? What's the entertainment? And who wants to walk away hungry or not have a good drink, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Absolutely. Great to speak with you, Shane.
Yeah, mate, lovely meeting you.
Gentlemen, thank you.
Yeah,
enjoy your time here.
All the best. You must have, like, recurring dreams about the amount of food you got to prepare, so we should get out of your hair, mate.
I'm just wondering when the phone's going to start ringing off the hook.
good luck.
On you, mate.
Have a great weekend.
To it. Thank you very much for that, Shane. We appreciate it. Fascinating chat.
Yeah.
What a world to be in.
The logistics of doing that, the scale of planning and ordering menus for 16,000 and then the timelines that you'd be working to. It must be like the, you know, planning the D-Day landing. Incredible.
Shane Krebs, the group executive chef at the Gemma Group. It is 25 minutes after 6. We might have a quick look at the news headlines from trackside this morning. Starting with the big development yesterday. Major crime detectives were on the York Peninsula where the search for wanted gunman Kevin Jewell ended. A body was found near his ute on a dirt track at Karramulka yesterday afternoon with no suspicious circumstances. The 55-year-old was wanted over the murder of his estranged wife at Modbury North on Tuesday. Family friend Adam Williams has told Nine News it's very hard to comprehend what happened the past few days.
I'm just sad and disgusted. I'm just mortified by his actions, by what's going on. Just absolutely speechless.
I thought the front page headline of today's Tizer says it all, a coward to the end. No other way to describe this waste of human life. What a gutless, loathsome scumbag of a bloke. And importantly, I was talking last night to Aman Ebrahimzadeh, lost his own mum, as everyone knows, through domestic violence. There's a big rally on the steps of Parliament at 9 a.m. this morning. Anyone who's in town, male, female, whatever, if you've got some spare time, maybe just go and stand there for a few minutes, because a lot of women and men, like Aman, but a lot of people across the border work in domestic violence are saying 4 deaths in South Australia in a week. We can't just shrug our shoulders about this. Victoria had a royal commission into it. There's a very strong argument for us doing that too, to work out what can change. We're going to do a big interview on Monday about that, by the way.
Yep. The bargain hunters will be on the prowl this Black Friday. Westfield Marion, Tea Tree Plaza and Westlakes will be open through until 9 o'clock tonight. And this will be exciting for you, David. Harbour Town is holding a 13-hour shopping marathon. I think they want you to be along for all 13 hours as sort of a patron of Black Friday. Rundle Mall.
Do you reckon we've got some sales rep who's trying to build up a big relationship with Harbour Town and they're trying to delete the entirety of yesterday's program after what I said about it?
Rundle Mall is Black Friday central in the city too. The Rundle Mall general manager, Andrew White, says it's a good chance to get a head start on Christmas present buying.
It really does signify the start of the Christmas period, and it is a great opportunity for shoppers to get in and do all their Christmas shopping and stretch their dollar further.
Police have infiltrated another arm of Australia's organised drug crime with a $68.5 million drug bust in central Queensland. Six people have been arrested during the Rosedale raid, which netted more than 13,500 cannabis plants and more than 15 kilos of the dried version of the drug. Inspector Bradley Phelps says investigations are underway into the ties between the property and another grow house that was raided earlier this month.
We say they're all related. It's Vietnamese organised crime. There's certainly links between the grow farms and the syndicates that are behind the operations.
An increase to childcare subsidies for low-income families is being recommended by the Productivity Commission. The key economic advisory body has handed down a draft report examining ways to make the sector more accessible. It's also warning more must be done to attract and retain early childhood education staff amid workforce shortages across the nation. Well, early childhood education was the subject of a Royal Commission just recently in South Australia.
And a big part of it is the paltry amount of money that people get paid.
Yeah.
It's been treated for too long like babysitting, that sector, when it's actually got, you know, a huge role to play in terms of educating kids when their brains most need it.
8223 0000 or the Dutton's text line 0408 1395. Experience the all-new Amarok with Dutton's extended test drive. Dutton's, easy to do business with. We've got some Meat Tray Friday entries that are coming through at the moment. Kaz in Brompton says, morning speed races. The number plate I remember is from when I was a kid. Mum made a little ditty to remind me what it was. RHC 482, she says. Richard has cats 482. Nowadays, don't ask me what my own phone number is, though, says Kaz. Thank you for that. Jane on the Foodland Supermarkets Facebook live streams watching our setup here trackside and says, you guys are really punching above your pay grade in that setup. Looking really relaxed when you should be getting revved up.
Oh, yeah, plenty of time for that.
Don't worry about that.
Stick around.
You don't want to peak too early.
Might fire up the Kluger again.
On a race day. Diana simply wrote, wow. So,
yeah, wow.
That could be about any number of things over the course of the first half an hour on the program.
Do you reckon there's a nudier car than a Toyota Kluger?
I didn't think it until I saw it on pit straight.
It's the most emasculating vehicle.
Take it away.
Okay.
Take it away.
I like this one. Hey, Dave, where are your dad's car being used in a bank robbery? I had a Peugeot many years ago in the early 80s, and I sold it to two dubious guys. I was young, and I said, I'll need their details on the rego sale to transfer the car. They said, oh, don't worry about that. We'll take in the paperwork for you when we make the department aware of the new owners, which I thought was nice of them to do. And a week later, the police came around, just like they did with your old man. Same thing, my Peugeot had been used in a robbery. There you go. Be careful who you give your car away to.
More common than you think, it turns out.
Especially if the person's wearing a balaclava. Often a warning sign.
Yeah, okay. Good tip. 5AA News is coming up. We'll be back shortly from the Velo Adelaide 500, chatting with Tommy Wren.
This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Showers easing in 22 with the 6:30 news. I'm Kendall Brettig.
Complete windscreen supply and fit front, rear and door glass. Proudly South Australian since 1976.
The temporary ceasefire between Israel and Hamas will start at 3:30 this afternoon our time. The pause in fighting will last for 4 days, with 13 women and children hostages to be released on the first day and handed over to the Red Cross. Qatari Foreign Ministry spokesman Dr. Majed Al Ansari says the meetings with foreign leaders were very positive.
The result, of course, was the implementation plan of the agreement, which we have always said needed to be something that is concrete and very ready to create a safe environment for the release of the hostages.
The manhunt for wife killer Kevin Jewell has ended after his body was found on the York Peninsula yesterday. A statewide hunt was launched after he shot and killed his estranged wife Jodie at their Modbury North home on Tuesday night. Domestic violence campaigners say they don't want her death to be in vain. Tomorrow, Rotary will hold a Walk for Respect parade from Victoria Square to King William Street starting at 9:30. Police have laid charges more than a year after a 5-year-old boy drowned in floodwaters in central western New South Wales. The child died after becoming stuck inside a vehicle which entered a flooded crossing near Parks. The 38-year-old driver's been charged with manslaughter and dangerous driving occasioning death. There's a push for a major funding boost to make childcare more accessible around the nation. More from Zach De Silva.
The Productivity Commission says all families should be able to access early childhood education at least 3 days a week. In a draft report, the economic advisory body's urging the federal government to provide extra support in communities where there aren't enough commercial childcare operators. The commission's also calling for greater subsidies for lower income families to make care more affordable. Labor says it's already making progress on some of the recommendations. The final report is due mid-next year.
Mining magnate Gina Rinehart is continuing her push for the Gold Coast and Perth to co-host the 2026 Commonwealth Games. The billionaire has written a letter to the Prime Minister pleading for him to restore the country's tarnished reputation after Victoria walked away from its hosting duties. However, Anthony Albanese's previously ruled out any financial support for the event. It's Black Friday and we can shop till we drop in what's fast becoming the biggest day on the retail calendar. Harbour Town is holding a 13-hour shopping marathon. While there'll be late-night shopping in the metro area at Westfield, Marion, Tea Tree Plaza and West Lakes. Rundle Mall will open for bargain hunters at 8 a.m. The mall's general manager, Andrew White, has this advice.
I would suggest plan ahead, get in early and know what you're after.
Turning to 5AA Sport.
Gliderol Garage Doors new Platinum and Native Series sectional doors are here. Gliderol.com.au.
Here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Kendall. India has won the opening T20 match against Australia by 2 wickets in a thriller to open their 5-match series. The Aussies smashed 3 for 208 from their 20 overs, but it wasn't enough as the home side reached the target with one ball to spare. Meantime, the Adelaide Strikers women will be in action tonight in an action-packed doubleheader, with the Brisbane Heat taking on the Sydney Thunder before the Strikers host the Perth Scorchers in the late game. And a win for the Strikers would see them secure a home grand final. To golf now, and Spain's Joel Moscatel Nashon has equaled the course record at Royal Queensland during the opening round of the Australian PGA Championship to lead at 8-under. Aussie Minwoo Lee is hot on his heels though with a sizzling 7-under round of 64 to begin the tournament, and Lee says he's been happy with his start.
Pretty stress-free, had control of my ball and putted pretty well, but my approach play was pretty solid, which you need around this course, and everything went well.
Audio there thanks to Nine. Adam Scott is also in the mix at 5-under, just 3 shots back. World tennis captain Leighton Hewitt is denying complacency could be a problem in Australia's Davis Cup semi-final against Finland. The Aussies will start hot favourites tomorrow morning, but Hewitt says the Finnish side will be a handful.
They're going to be coming in very confident, and we'll be doing our homework. We'll be absolutely doing everything in our power to go out there and do take care of business, but we certainly won't be taking them lightly at all.
And in some soccer to finish, Sam Kerr's Chelsea will be in Champions League action again this morning as her side takes on Paris FC. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Now the 5AA Forecast.
Stay cool. Service your aircon at Automasters. And keep cool with Cool Now, Pay Later options.
Showers easing in 22 today, showers tomorrow 20, cloudy on Sunday 21 and more of the same Monday 20. At the moment 15. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Breakfast on 5AA, David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
If you're living with a disability, injury or health condition and looking for work, visit maxima.com.au.
Be coming with me. 24 minutes to 7, lots of course, coming through for Meat Tray Friday on 8223-0000. Thanks to Corinthian Meats, family-owned business, Peter the Dad, Harry the Son, support local and buy from local. We're asking about memorable number plates you've had over the course of the journey, inspired, of course, by the fact that we're talking cars this morning. We're trackside at the Velo Adelaide 500. So we're not talking necessarily personalised number plates. We've had great people with number plates they remembered because of colourful ditties they came up with. Some that were significant, some they remembered because the police contacted them after the fact to tell them that car had subsequently been used in a bank robbery. Whatever the story might well be, we're happy to hear it. 8223-0000. We've got a couple of calls ready to go. No, not yet. We will get to some of those calls. And then we'll catch up with Tom Wren.
I'm a bit nervous about doing this hot lap. I'm going to ask the driver if we can try to keep it to, 100, 110, maybe. How fast is this car going to go out there?
fast as it can, I would have thought.
I did one years ago at Oran Park in Sydney with Mark Scaife, and he was just, well, being Mark Scaife, he...
But that, you're actually in a supercar then, weren't you?
Yeah.
Ah,
yeah.
Well, this is a road vehicle.
Yeah, so it's just like a normal car, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
So it's like a safety car or something.
It's the, well, I don't think they call it safety car anymore. They call it the course car.
Course car.
Safety sounds like something bad's going to happen. Let's go to Alex and Andrew's farm. Morning to you, Alex.
Morning, gents. How are you?
Good, thanks, Alex.
Good. Well, a friend of a friend of a friend, basically, wanted to be a bit of a smartass and have a sexual innuendo kind of a number plate. So he got knocked back a couple of times, and eventually he got UB6, IB9 through.
Thank you, Alex.
Yes.
You got to be clever.
Sausant neuf. Trebien.
Someone at the... some of the transport department, the licensing department went, oh, I can't see anything wrong with
it. Yeah, it was like some elderly Methodist lady who only worked once a week. She got
sounds lovely.
This person must just like the number 6 and 9.
Wayne in Taparoo, good morning.
Good morning, lad. In my role with Littlehampton Bricks, I have a company car, so the current number plate I have is Brick, but my last one was Paver, and the one before that was Paving, and we've got Bricks. And Pave as well.
Oh, that's good, mate.
Makes sense. Pays
good plug for the company. Great Adelaide business.
Good on you, Wayne. Magnificent work. Let's go to Point Pass. Maureen, good morning.
Good morning, men. 1,000 years ago, I used to drive a taxi down in Adelaide. And it was in a time where there weren't many women. And every morning I'd clock in and everybody would cheer, and I never knew why for ages until I realised my call sign was Gay 6-9.
Now, Maureen, I've got to say, you must have been the only female taxi driver in Adelaide. How long ago was it?
That was, I was still married to somebody else and I lived at Parra Hills, in the 60s.
Really?
So yeah,
how many
I'm
other women were driving
old.
Cabs
you
then?
You realise I'm 1,000 years old, don't you?
You're not a dad.
How long?
70.
A few years. I started in Elizabeth and then they promoted me to the city. And I used
to
sit
out...
What
was it like being a female taxi driver?
Sometimes it was a bit nasty. But I had a little spray full of nasty stuff to squirt at nasty people.
Like a bit of mace?
No, hairspray.
Okay.
Did you ever have to deploy the hairspray?
The reason they liked me is because they used to get me to pick up kids from school.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, of course.
The market corner.
And also... outside the hospital, ladies used to like me. And I had a special customer once, a very important chap who used to be in the Adelaide hospital, who had become injured at one time and he had to be dumped in the car. We had to pull him in, you know. But he used to like to sit in the front with me, so I used to lean over and pull right across the car and pull him till we were arm in arm in the front of the car, and he used to say, "This is the best time of the day."
Oh, wow. What a lovely call, Maureen.
Many and varied experiences in your life, Maureen, and we always appreciate you calling in to share them with us. Thank you very much for your call. 822-300-00 for Meat Tray Friday. In the meantime, we're heading back to Hindmarsh, where Tom Wren is in position as we'll talk sport thanks to Gliderol Garage Doors, adding strength, safety and style to South Australian homes for over 40 years. Gliderol.com.au. Morning, Rennie.
Morning, Will. Morning, David. Now, fellas, I assume and take it for granted that you stayed up and watched the first of the 5 T20s last night between Australia and India.
This is just like a classic example of cricket over-scheduling itself into irrelevance, isn't it? What? And how about the photo? The best photo I've seen all week was Travis Head getting off the plane. He looked like he has been celebrating with the same enthusiasm he was batting.
I was going to say, is he almost taken David Byrne's mantle for celebration?
Some of the photographs that have emerged.
Pretty good, aren't they? But you're right. I mean... it really deserved its own sort of time slot, didn't it, in terms of the Australian team coming home, showing off the trophy. I mean, we were talking about it on Monday morning, saying it might be the greatest ever World Cup triumph, and we've won six of them, and yet here they are playing 4 days later, and we know why they're doing it, Cricket Australia, it's for the money, but it's just, oh, it's a bit smelly, isn't it?
What was the crowd like, Rennie?
Pretty good. I mean, as you know, over there, they love it. So it was solid. But, I mean, I think the care factor, even for the Indian players, they've got a shadow of their side in as well. They've only got a couple of players that, you know, played in the One Day World Cup as well. So I just don't think, after such an exhausting tournament, you know, it's hard to get motivated for this, isn't it?
You could have told me that Australia was playing an extraterrestrial 11 and I wouldn't have watched it last night, 2020 cricket.
Not that anyone cares, Tom, but who won the game?
India did. So, Josh Inglis, right. I was going to play some audio, but I feel a bit... I better play it for him. Josh Inglis, he made 100 last night and batted really well.
Well played, young man. What a moment that'll be for him. Class all around the wicket. Front foot, back foot. Gets pace and spin.
Hey, I know we've got the Adelaide 500 and you guys are doing a great job. It sounds brilliant down there. If people are looking for something to do tonight, there's a double header for the cricket. Speaking of the Adelaide Strikers, the women, if they win, they get a home grand final. So we love it when we win silverware. They won it last season and could do it again. The other thing that I thought was interesting was yesterday, Charlie Hodgson, the SACA president, and look, I guess it's just a sign of the times, but, you know, the old scoreboard, you've got batsmen and bowlers. So obviously the gender of the batsman, well, that's changing. As of today, it's going to be just say batting and bowling, because obviously now there's a lot of, you know, women's matches that happen at the ground. So, you know, it's going to be gender neutral with just batting and, you know, the list of the batters that come down. And then bowling. So, you know, not batsmen anymore. So I thought that was a fun little fact that I could share with you this morning.
I was at the... saw it getting repainted, Rennie. I did the roof climb at Adelaide Oval.
No way!
A week or so ago, and the scaffolding was all around the scoreboard, and they were making the point that the painstaking effort to try to get it matched to the rest of the old scoreboard. Because could you imagine the outrage if it looked slightly different?
Yep.
People will lose their minds. So they're desperate to make sure the aesthetic of the scoreboard remains the same.
Wow.
As the content changes.
What did you think? Like, or was it too early? The fresh paint was still going on when
couldn't
you were
see
up
it,
there?
So, yeah, couldn't see it. It was just all covered in scaffolding at that point in time.
Right.
So the final product remains to be seen.
Yeah, well, we'll see that tonight. And look, the Adelaide 500 should be outstanding this weekend. I mean, you boys are there. It's a great atmosphere. Robbie on Sunday. And, you know, from a purely sporting point of view, it's great that the championship is still alive going into the final round. It's great that we've got a live, you know, Shane van Gisbergen versus Brody Kostecki. Just adds a little bit more theatre, so should be a cracking weekend in terms of just purest racing. It's really exciting from that perspective.
Yeah, everyone's hoping down here, Rennie, it gets through to that Sunday. And maybe the rain and turn eight will combine to make sure that happens. Good on you, Rennie.
Good on you, boys. Have a great weekend.
You too, Tom.
Glideroll Garage Doors, new Platinum and Native Series sectional doors are here, glideroll.com.au. All right, we're going to check traffic. Thanks to Keezer. If you're tired of back pain, we'll try Keezer, Keeser.com.au.
Thanks, Will, and good morning. Heavy showers last night, so take it easy on the odd damp road this morning. Look out for lights on the blink at Torrens Park, Blair Road at Springbank Road. Damaged barrier at Medindie is still slowing things up today. Main North Road near Nottage Terrace, and road closures continue for the Adelaide 500 today. Look out for lots of people heading along around Caterville Terrace and Bartels Road today on the way to work. Cameras today, Adelaide Terrace, Edwardstown, and Beckman Street at Glandore. Freedom's biggest Black Friday event is on. Get 30% off store-wide, including all sofas, furniture, outdoor and homewares. Don't miss out. Salads Monday, only at Freedom. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Get great value Christmas gifts this Black Friday at Coles. Like selected gift cards from TCN, now 15% off. Redeemable at JB Hi-Fi and more. That's great value, hands down, at Coles. In-store only, excludes TCN variable load cards. Offer ends Tuesday, limits and T's and C's apply.
Get saving now with City Discount Tyres. We're offering great deals on the world's top brands in tyres, wheels, suspension and parts. Suitable for four-wheel drives, SUVs and passenger cars, including Falcon, Michelin, Pirelli, Kumho, Hankook and many more. Finance options available. Search citydiscounttyres.com.au and locate your nearest dealer today. City Discount Tyres. We're driven by value. City Discount Tyres.
Destiny RVSA is your caravan superstore, your one-stop caravan shop. New or used, they've got the right caravan for your adventure and your budget.
Their fully equipped service department will ensure safe travels for you and your family with all the parts you need. And if your van gets damaged in any way, remember Destiny RVSA is also an RAA-approved repairer and fully qualified crash shop.
Plus, right now, Destiny RVSA have the all-new MY24 New Age Caravan range ready for delivery this Christmas.
That's right. Have your MY24 New Age van before the big man comes to town. Walk and Shaw have been busy innovating and developing the best New Age caravan range, complete with their new modern looks and features. So pop in and see the team at Destiny RVSA and take a look, Northeast Road Valley View, or visit destinyrvsa.com.au.
So, you want to do your bit for the planet? Drink Fleurio Milk Company milk, now available in a glass bottle, no plastic, no waste. Fleurio Milk Company have partnered with The Udder Way to bring you milk in a glass bottle. Look for milk refill stations in your supermarket, purchase your own glass bottle, fill it, take it home, drink it and bring it back to use again. No plastic, no waste. Visit fleuriomilkco.com.au for locations.
If you're constipated and struggling to poo, here's some great news. Introducing Caruso's Constipation Ease. Caruso's Constipation Ease is a new herbal and fibre combination containing cascara, yellow dock, fennel and green banana powder. These help to relieve constipation by making it easier for you to poo. So if you're struggling to poo and would like to poo more, why not try Caruso's Constipation Ease? Caruso's Constipation Ease is available from leading pharmacies and health stores. Always read the label and follow the directions for use.
Austrac Camper's space-saving designs mean you can stretch out in a luxury king-size bed that your queen will still steal the covers off, honey.
Oh.
Austrac Campers!
Breakfast on 5AA. David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
Jobs, apprenticeships, traineeships and careers. Maxima can help. Learn more today at maxima.com.au.
11 to 7. More Meat Tray Friday calls coming your way in just a moment. Thanks to Corinthian Meats. Memorable number plates we're talking this morning, inspired by cars as we are broadcasting live from the Velo Adelaide 500. Let's check in with the Weather Bureau first, though. Simon Timke is on duty. And Simon, I'll tell you what, if you're coming to the end of the track today, you'd be very interested in the weather forecast. But the good news, it feels like we've had a fair whack of the rain that was due to come.
Recorded generally across the metro area 10 to 20 millimetres since 9 a.m. yesterday, with some local falls in the 20 to 30 millimetre range. The wettest spots were about the eastern slopes of the hills. Mount Torrens picked up 31 millimetres, 27 millimetres at Mount Pleasant. Here in Adelaide, we've recorded 22.6 millimetres, so pretty wet 24 hours. Looking at the radar at the moment, most of that rain has contracted well to the south and west of the Adelaide area, and we're clear of showers about the Adelaide area right now. And I think as the day goes on, there will probably be a chance of seeing a little bit more shower activity redevelop. The winds will turn around to a southwesterly a bit later this morning, and I think we'll see a couple of showers push up in that onshore southwesterly airstream. So a dry start, plenty of cloud about, but I think we will see some showers on and off during that later morning and afternoon period, and easing during the evening, becoming less frequent again during the evening. Temperature-wise, currently sitting on 15.5 degrees in the city after an overnight minimum of 14.5, which occurred about 20 to 1 this morning, and expecting a maximum of 22 degrees for the city today, 22 as well for Elizabeth, 21 degrees for Glenelg, Mount Barker and Norlunga. Over the weekend, still some showers about for Saturday, expecting a maximum of 20 degrees. The showers, I think, will be more confined to the hills and southern suburbs on Sunday in a southerly airstream, 21 degrees for Sunday. And then Monday, Tuesday, just a slight chance of a shower around, again, mostly about the hills and southern suburbs, staying pretty cool, 20 degrees for Monday, 21 for Tuesday, and then warming up a little bit for Wednesday and Thursday, 23 and partly cloudy for Wednesday, and some sunshine for Thursday by the looks of it, 24 degrees. So hopefully a good day for the race, but you want to be ready for a couple of showers about the place today and tomorrow.
Good stuff, Simon. Makes for an exciting day on the track, that's for sure. Simon Timke at the Bureau of Meteorology. Let's head to SAPOL. Senior Constable Rebecca Stokes joins us Rebecca, three youths have been arrested in a stolen car overnight.
Yes, so police spotted an Audi sedan travelling at speed on Slate Scully Road at Burnside about 12:15am overnight. Checks revealed that that car had been stolen during a house break-in at Seacliff Park on Wednesday. Police didn't pursue the vehicle but saw it stop at locked gates leading to a quarry. The vehicle then drove at speed, smashing through the gates and then collided with a bollard. Four youths were seen to run from the car and into the quarry and surrounding bushland. So police quickly set up cordons and brought in police dog Chaos to search the area. They caught three of the youths a short distance away on Willow Bridge Grove at Burnside and arrested them. So far we've been unable to locate that fourth youth. The boys are aged 2 15-year-olds and a 14-year-old from Seacombe Gardens and Sturt. They've all been arrested for illegal use, drive without due care and attention, and fail to truly answer. And we're still making some inquiries to identify and locate that fourth youth. Fortunately, there doesn't appear to have been any serious injuries, but we really do want to check on the welfare of that fourth teenager that's outstanding.
And Rebecca, sadly, given the week we've had, yet another fatality on the roads yesterday at Glandore.
Yes, this one happened in the middle of the day, 12:20pm, Anzac Highway, Glandore. Police were called after reports of a vehicle colliding with a tree. The driver and sole occupant of the vehicle was a 26-year-old Andrews farm man. He was taken to the Royal Adelaide Hospital but sadly died a short time after arrival. And if you saw the pictures on the news last night, you'll see that, car versus tree, and it seemed like the driver's side door really took the impact of that crash. So quite a horrific scene there for everyone involved. Anzac Highway was closed for several hours while major crash officers attended and examined the scene, and they're preparing a report into this man's death, which is the 103rd life lost on South Australian roads so far this year. The road toll last time was 61. So, as you mentioned, we're just having an absolute shocker, and it continues to go that way this year.
I don't know how that car ended up that out of control. I know that stretch of road like the back of my hand just near on the run, and, you know, it's three lanes wide, you know, visibility.
Yep, people still manage to hit trees on Anzac Highway.
How do you do it? Unbelievable.
And Rebecca also asked, it's been leading our news services throughout the morning, but the manhunt for Kevin Jewell ended yesterday with the location of his body.
Yes, fortunately we had the information from the public. Following a tip-off, we attended a property at Curramulka about 11:30 yesterday morning, and there we located the suspect's white 2008 Mitsubishi Triton ute and also found the man deceased. He was about 150 metres away from the car. We do believe that man is 55-year-old Kevin Jewell. He was wanted by police in relation to the murder of 55-year-old Jody Jewell at their Modbury North home on Tuesday. We had launched a massive manhunt for him and asked the media and the public to help us to keep an eye out for him and his vehicle. So we're really pleased to get that information yesterday and bring this to a conclusion. And now Major Crime Detectives and Forensic Response Section, they'll be conducting a coronial investigation into the man's death. There's no suspicious circumstances at this time. And once again, just thanking the public and everyone involved for their assistance.
Good on you, Rebecca. Thank you for that.
Thanks, Rebecca.
Thank you.
Councillor Rebecca Stokes from SAPOL. Now, I just note, trackside, a lot of the marshals are out on the track, hovering on the pit area. I imagine some of the teams is sort of just making things, get things ready for race day. And pulling up right next to us, just 10 metres away, is an ambulance, which I understand is in place ahead of David's hot lap after 7:30. They wanted it nice and close in case they needed to, you know, do any emergency
work. I just want to know a bit about who's driving the car.
No, I'm told they haven't had an incident for, it's been a year or two.
Yeah, good. That's right.
Brian in Ingle Farms called in with the meat tray Friday entry. Morning to you, Brian.
Morning, David and Will. My story doesn't concern my own fate, but since the inception of a specialised case, this one caught my eye, was UPY002. And I thought the message was fairly clever.
What was the message?
UPY002.
Yes, that's right. It makes
my brain must be working this early. UPY002.
Try up as the start of the sentence.
Up, 002?
Y-002.
This is like a cryptic crossword. I'm going to spend the rest of the morning working on this one, mate.
Well, just very quickly, I'd like to give you another one that I spied a few weeks ago.
Sure, let's do it.
It was AAMRSH, and it poses to me a rhetorical question, which I'd like to leave with you.
All right. Thank you. Thank you, Brian.
That's really some real brain busters there from Brian. He's seeing things that I can't see.
Maybe you need to see. Maybe it's more of a visual.
Yeah.
Might be more of a have a visual impact. Okay. Well, the question is, and Brian did answer it, number plates that are have been meaningful to you, have maybe had a meaning only to you, like they did.
Hidden meaning.
Yeah. But we've had people like Kaz in Brompton had a number plate that only had a meaning to her because her mum came up with a ditty that helped them remind it. Maybe it has some significance to you because of the numbers involved or the combination of letters. License plates that mean something, be it funny or memorable for you. 8223 00. You can text us too on the Dutton's text line 0408 08 1395. Back from the Velo Adelaide 500 right after this.
Rising cost of living pressures are hitting everyone, some people more than others. If you're struggling with your home loan or credit card payments, there may be ways your bank can help. Like lowering your home loan or credit card payments, restructuring the length of your loan to reduce them, moving you to interest-only payments for a while, or deferring them for a period. Don't tough it out on your own. Please. Talk to your bank.
5AA's Tech Talk with your host, Adelaide Tech Guy Richard Pascoe. Thanks to Harvey Norman Computers.
Black Friday has become a huge day for savvy shoppers and Harvey Norman has big savings on computers. They've taken up to 30% off all Windows 11 computers, including the Lenovo Yoga Slim and Intel Evo device. Powered by a Core i5 CPU, 16GB of RAM and a super-fast 512GB solid-state drive, this computer is perfect for work or schooling needs. The Intel Evo platform gives a computer the ability to have instant wake-up for quick boot-ups and a real-world battery life of 9.5 hours. It also comes with a 14-inch 2K resolution screen for a great image. Get the Lenovo Yoga Slim at the special Black Friday price of just $898. That's a saving of $400. Save during Black Friday week at Harvey Norman.
Check out this great offer at a Harvey Norman store near you.
G'day, it's Rory Sloane. The Kluger 7-seat SUV with a brand new sophisticated design and powerful on-road stance. Your choice of an economical and powerful all-wheel drive hybrid engine or improved 2-litre 4-cylinder turbo engine, plus Toyota's latest safety technology designed to support safe driving. This 7-seater has flexible cargo space thanks to the folding second and third rows. Take a test drive of the new Kluger today at Jarvis Toyota, South Road, Clovelly Park. Proudly celebrating 21 years of great deals.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube.
Online, on DAB Digital Radio and on 1395 AM. Talking Adelaide. This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Zhao Zizing in 22 with the 7 o'clock news. I'm Kendall Brettig.
Chipped windscreen? Complete Windscreens can repair it from just $99. Look for the big red koala.
The armed wing of Hamas has confirmed the four-day pause in fighting in Gaza will begin at 3:30 this afternoon our time. Four fuel trucks and 200 aid trucks will also be allowed to enter the strip on each of those days. Qatari Foreign Ministry spokesman Dr. Majid Al Ansari says the criteria on who's to be released is purely humanitarian.
They will be 13 in number, all women and children, and those hostages who are from the same families will be put together within the same patch. Obviously, every day will include a number of civilians as agreed to total 50 within the 4 days.
Authorities are scrambling to find out how a group of asylum seekers reached Australian shores. 12 people were on board a vessel from Indonesia which arrived in WA's remote north. Border Force is yet to confirm any details about the arrival. A man's been charged with dangerous driving during severe floods in New South Wales, resulting in a child's death. Madeline McNeil reports.
In September last year, as floods ravaged the region, a Toyota Hilux became submerged in a creek northwest of Parkes. Four family members managed to free themselves from the vehicle and cling to trees until help arrived, but a five-year-old boy was trapped inside. His body was recovered the following day. After an extensive investigation, the 38-year-old driver has been charged with manslaughter and dangerous driving, occasioning death. He'll face court in January.
A drink driver blew nearly four times over the legal limit in rainy conditions at Hallett Cove overnight. Police detected his vehicle speeding at 100 k's in an 80 zone on Lonsdale Road around 1:30. The driver, a 50-year-old McLaren Vale man, recorded a blood alcohol reading of 0.194. He's been reported for speeding and drink driving, and his vehicle's been impounded for 28 days. The federal government's being urged to make sure all families can access childcare at least 3 days a week. The Productivity Commission's handed down a draft report examining ways to make the sector more accessible. It's also calling on the government to increase childcare subsidies for lower-income families. Early Childhood Minister Anne Alley won't be drawn on Labor's response to the findings, but says there are clear issues that must be addressed.
It really kind of confirms things that we kind of already knew about, where there is a lack of supply, particularly in rural and regional areas, the fact that First Nations children are underrepresented in early childhood education and care.
People can expect longer delays when transferring money to someone new as Australian banks launch a new scam software. The big four and smaller branches are introducing a scam safe accord to better protect customers. $100 million is being invested in rolling out a new confirmation of the payee system. And retailers are hoping Black Friday and Cyber Monday sales will be the spark Australian businesses need after a flat year of sales. The National Retail Association saw consumer confidence slightly increase before it was knocked back by the latest interest rate hike. Director Rob Godwin says many consumers will still be trying to make the most of industry-wide discounts in the coming days.
Over the Cyber Weekend, there'd be around about $6.3 billion spent. That kind of represents around about 10 to 12% of the income for the year.
Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Gliderol Garage Doors, adding strength, safety and style to South Australian homes for over 40 years. Gliderol.com.au.
And Tom Renner, loss for the Aussies in the cricket.
Yeah, not great. Fortunately, it wasn't the World Cup final though, Kendall. Nonetheless, they have lost their opening T20 match against India. That's after they went down by two wickets in a bit of a thriller overnight. Josh Inglis smashed his maiden international century, but it wasn't enough as the home side reached the 209-run target with one ball to spare. To golf now, players are out on the course to begin round two of the Australian PGA Championship, which is being played at Royal Queensland. Spaniard Joel Moscatel, Nashon, is still the man to catch at 8-under. Well, the focus is on championship contenders Brody Kostecki and Shane van Gisbergen at the Supercars season-ending Adelaide 500 this weekend. However, it was Chas Mostert who set the pace in the first practice session yesterday, with both Kostecki and van Gisbergen finishing well down the timesheet. Australia's tennis players will have a light hit out today ahead of tomorrow morning's Davis Cup semi-final against Finland. Serbia is looking like they'll progress to the final after Mimoar Kecmanovic won his opening rubber against Jack Draper. That was 7-6, 7-6. Novak Djokovic is now on court against Cameron Norrie and is up a break of serve in the first set. Meantime, Nick Kyrgios is no certainty to play in January's Australian Open. The world number 192 has played just one match this year, having battled a knee injury. Australian Open boss Craig Tiley says they're hoping Kyrgios will be fit to play and he will be at the major regardless.
Doing more off-court things, which I know he'll be announcing as well, and I've seen some of the initial work on that, and I think Nick's position will be determined closer to the event, but any time we can get Nick, it's great for everyone.
Yeah, it would be fantastic to see him playing again. That is the 5AA Sport.
Now checking 5AA traffic.
Reimagine your home, elevate your life at 88 O'Connell Street Luxury Apartments. See 88oconnell.com.
Morning there, heavy showers overnight, so take it easy on damp roads this morning. Look out for lights on the blink at Torrens Park, Blair Road at Springbank Road. Damaged barriers slowing the drive drive-in at Bedindi, Main North Road near Nottage Terrace. And road closures continue for Adelaide 500. Lots of folk heading along today, so look out for them around Caterville Terrace and Bartels Road in the drive-in. You'll find cameras South Road, Edwardstown and Wood Street at Millswood. Fill up with Shell V-Power 98, the premium fuel designed to deliver greater efficiency and improved performance. It's a decision you can feel good about. Details online. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Stay cool. Service your aircon at Automasters. And keep cool with Cool Now, Pay Later options.
Showers easing today, a high of 22. Showers tomorrow, 20. Cloudy on Sunday, 21. And cloudy again for Monday, 20. At the moment, 15. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Breakfast on 5AA, David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
Jobs, apprenticeships, traineeships and careers. Maxima can help. Learn more today at maxima.com.au.
7 after 7, good morning to you joining us for the very first time on this Friday morning. We are broadcasting live from Pitt Strait at the Velo Adelaide 500. If you're watching along on the Foodland Supermarkets Facebook and YouTube live stream, you'll see behind us there's this spectacular digital board. If you look closely and squint, you get this, you get the real vibe. And if you haven't been down here before, it's hard to put it into words. But the entire event beyond the racing is a celebration of cars. And you can look behind us and see a course car that's a Mustang. There was a Hyundai that went past before. There's a hotted up old ute that I didn't see the make of that was cruising around as well. And every now and then a different vehicle comes by and people, whether people doing utility work on the track or getting things ready, because we're right next to the pits. It's all crackling to life now. The sun is up down here. It's a spectacular day.
The weather looks better than we were led to believe too.
Yeah.
It's going to change around a bit during the day, but at the moment, like, blue skies out there.
It's going to make some for exciting racing. It might well make for a situation where the championship's ultimately decided on the final day. And that's something that I know everyone down here is cheering for. We're going to chat with Mark Warren, the CEO of South Australian Motorsport, in a moment. He might not be aware of this, though, but we do have to report that before 6 o'clock this morning, there was an illegal incursion onto the track.
I want names.
You might be sitting next to one, Mark.
That's why Mark's here.
There was a Toyota Kluger that made its way onto Pitt Strait. No one knows why or how, but thankfully, we captured video of David arriving at 5 to 6 this morning. It had to be captured for all time and maybe for an investigation a little bit later. If you're watching on the Foodland Supermarkets Facebook and YouTube live stream, you can see David cruising down Pitt Strait. Let's have a look.
You're right, we're here. Stop, David. Stop.
So it's before 5 minutes before the show and David's rolled up and somehow he's on the Adelaide 500 track.
In my defence.
Because there's a major race lead on this weekend.
Yeah, you can turn left up there to get back it up.
I've got to say, it's not the fastest navigation of Pitt Strait we're going to see this weekend.
You can hear in the background, my favourite part of that video is Sam in the background going, "We can see you! What are you doing?"
In my defence, it might have been 5 to 6 when I turned up out the front and you started filming me on your iPhone. I had actually been on the track for a full 10 minutes trying to find car park bloody A on account of taking a wrong turn. So I apologise to the race organisers. It was all a snafu on account of taking a wrong turn next to overpass number 2.
Mark, the track record was in no danger of being broken through the first sector.
No, it was not, and I think that we need to pass that to the stewards and see if the penalty is in order.
I was just waiting for someone to come out with a flag, like a safety flag or something like that. But I certainly wasn't exceeding the speed limit. But it was actually, in all honesty, Mark, I thought, crikey, I don't know if I should be out of here. But then as I was driving along, I thought, well, I'm here now, and I'm driving really slowly, and I'm trying to find, in all honesty, I'm trying to find the first exit possible, but it was actually a really good way to see the track.
It is a great way, and I've got to say that it's the fastest we've ever seen a Toyota Kluger down the main straight.
Yeah, they're not exactly built for speed, those things.
Is it a fair summation of the equation for today and the rest of the weekend that the weather makes you nervous crowd-wise, but excited race-wise?
I think that's always the fan response, and the worst of the weather looks like it's passed, and we've got blue skies today, so I think that we had the worst of it this morning, perhaps early wee small hours of the morning. So, look, things are a bit damp, but I encourage everyone to come down and put their walking shoes on, because there's just so much to see here, so much entertainment around the track. have a free ride on the giant Ferris wheel here. That will get you off the ground, get you out of the wet. But, you know, that's a 35-metre Ferris wheel. Fantastic. It's not going to stop the Showtime FMX guys, the ones that do the motocross freestyle, you know, doing the flips and the jumps. The BMX guys are really keen to get on the BMX track today and have some tricks there. So plenty to see and do.
Well, that's exactly right. I mean, you don't need to be a total petrol head to love it, because, you know, I mean, talking before to Sam, like the musical lineup, I reckon it's worth buying a ticket so you can see Ice House tomorrow night and Robbie Williams Sunday night.
Absolutely. I mean,
the tickets to the race are actually cheaper than the tickets to a lot of music festivals around town that sometimes don't actually have as good a lineup.
It's absolutely the best value ticket in town. I mean, it's having three after-race concerts starting tonight, plus all the entertainment and the racing. I mean, it's the championship decider, which you mentioned before. And I think there's so many motorsport fans that want to come down and see that. But then combine that with just the festival feel of everything here. Mm. It's just amazing, the atmosphere. And it's been great feedback from the supercar teams, because they go to all their events, of course, and they absolutely rate this one as the top event when it comes to the atmosphere and the feel. Being right next to the city, the whole city comes alive around this event. It's fantastic.
Yeah, it's good. And it's just crazy to think that we lost it for a while. And do you think the fact that we had that hiatus where it was canned, and, you know, don't mention the war, I'm sure you guys want to be all, you know, polite and not sort of take pot shots at anyone who may or may not have been involved in the cancellation of the race. But the fact that it's now back, has there been, because our listeners, like there's a Venn diagram, people who are here this weekend and people listen to 5AA, it overlaps pretty snugly. Has there been pent-up enthusiasm for the return of the V8s on account of them being axed for a couple of years there?
Absolutely. I mean, last year, bringing the event back was just fantastic, and the response was enormous. We're seeing the same thing this year, and that's always the risk. When you have the second year in, people think, oh, you know, is it going to be as big as, you know, bring it back the first time? Absolutely it is. And there's still some things that, you mentioned the war, there's some things that we had to, you know, replace for last year. A bunch of stuff got sold.
All the stuff, it was like when the Spaniards arrived in Mexico and they burnt their boats.
Yeah, so something like that. That's an interesting analogy.
Hernan Cortez.
But we've been very fortunate to, last year we brought a lot of stuff back. A few things to then bring back this year. I mean, the shade cover that we've got on the pit straight grandstand, absolutely fantastic. Looks better than what we had before. And it actually provides great rain cover too. So I know that the punters that were up in there yesterday really enjoyed having that cover. So it just adds to the amphitheatre that is down this pit straight. And the supercar teams have been saying, can you turn the noise down? Because, you know, the supercar sounds just bounce off the walls here, and it's just a great atmosphere.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, it's going to be a great weekend. It looks spectacular, I've got to say. You wouldn't know you've had to replace or change things. It looks absolutely state of the art. I'm just trying to think back to the very first supercars race. It must... if you'd been to the first in Adelaide and haven't been since, what do you think the biggest thing that'd stand out to you would be?
I think that it's transitioned from being a racing event to being a festival event.
Yeah.
You know, it really has...
Because you can walk around the middle here, can't you? And you wouldn't even know, beyond the sound, obviously, that you're at a race meet.
Pretty much. I mean, we've got over 70 bars and food outlets and so on here. So and all the family entertainment, the family zone with the big slippery slides and all those sorts of things. So families can come down here and have a great day out. And even if they've only got a love of cars and a cursory sort of love of the motorsport, it's still a great day out to come down and check it all out.
Absolutely. Well, it's great to be here, and it's going to be one hell of a weekend. I haven't been for donkey's years, so it's exciting to be here, Mark. And it's pretty chockers as well, isn't it? The sales have been terrific.
Sales have been fantastic, and it literally, I think the weather obviously has dampened things a little bit, you know, the last day and maybe a little bit today, but Saturday, Sunday is going to be awesome. The fact that the skies are clearing, I think we've got great confidence as to the crowd that we're going to get, the walk-up crowd on Saturday, Sunday. The feedback on the Kindig Custom Car Show too. I mean, we've got so many people who have come from interstate just to see Dave Kindig and Kevin Scheel, never been to Australia before. The cars, if you haven't gone to see them in the elite class, just spectacular. It's automotive art. So people who love cars, definitely come down and see that. All the other street elites that we've got in the big top and all the show and shine cars, over 150 cars here that are just absolutely smick.
We were speaking to Sam earlier too, some corporate hospitality availability today and tomorrow as well, if you want to come
and make a, you've just woken up this morning and thought, geez, that'd be a nice way to spend a weekend. And wouldn't it just be? Sunday's obviously all sold out. It's going to be a great weekend, Mark. All the best, and thanks for chatting with us.
No, thank you very much. Thanks, David. Thank
Good you on you, Mark. Thanks, Mark.
Mark Warren, the CEO of South Australian Motorsport Board. We're going to meet Trey Friday. That's somewhat car-inspired this morning, thanks to Corinthian Meats. We're asking you about notable number plates you've had. We actually got an explainer on the Dutton's text line by a couple of people, too, the call we had before, just before 7
Have they cracked the Da Vinci code?
They cracked the code. So, UPY002, we were being too literal with reading the numbers as numbers. Up you two.
Oh, up you two. Up you two. Do you think Brian was talking about us two?
I don't think he originally, I think subsequently, that's definitely what he's thinking. We're getting more entries on the Dutton's text line. Some calls, though, we want from the meat tray. 8223 000. Funny, notable, meaningful number plates you've had over the course of your car-owning life. Give us a call and you can win that meat tray by 9 o'clock today.
Hey, now, just quickly, this is the bit where I'm going to stuff up the format of the program. I am not going to go in that car after 7:30.
Okay.
I have no desire to exceed the speed limit at all.
Okay.
Particularly when it's been raining, and I don't want to sound ungrateful to the organisers who've gone to the trouble of arranging for someone so that I can sit in the front of a car spinning around a track at great speed. But I personally have no desire to do that as a father. And, you know, for the people who are here who can actually drive as their job and as part of entertainment and sport, and it's a legitimate sport, then good luck to them, and everyone can come here and watch that. But I could not, the idea of going at 160, 180, whatever speed it is, I've got no interest in doing it.
Okay.
Well. So I'm out. How about that? And the other thing too, I think as a listener, who gives a toss that some provincial Alan Partridge-style radio host is going zzz in a car?
Well, no, the hope would be that you're desperately uncomfortable, I guess.
Well, that'd I clearly am. And look, I'm not trying to, you know, rain on the parade here.
All right. Well,
but I just think, for me, the idea of speeding is not thrilling. And I think away from the track, the idea, the fewer people who can find the idea of speeding thrilling, the better off we'll all be.
Well, we are at the track today. So what we'll
so
do
how about
is,
that? Sorry, Sam.
We are celebrating motorsport today. Sam Datto.
I mean, I shouldn't have to explain the background why I particularly feel that way.
No, that's fine.
Today.
That's fine. Sam Datto is a total rev head who has done a hot
Sam should do it.
He will do it and film it, because what we want to do is have an experience for people on the Facebook live stream as well to be able to see what it's like herring around the track. So
I might be regarded as the biggest wuss in South Australia, but I'm just, you know.
You're out on speed.
I am officially puttering around in my car right now.
Is it also?
And I just got a text from my mum saying, you be careful out there, dear. And I think the more people can think like that about their kids, even if their kids happen to be 55 years old, the better off we'd all be.
Is it also because you already did a hot lap in the
Kluger? Well, yeah,
it's also taking the fun out of it.
I feel like I've ticked that box already.
Yeah, you've done that. You'd be greedy to go back for a second lap this morning.
But I just don't want to do it. I don't know. Okay. I just don't want to do it.
All right. Well, you don't have to.
Yeah, good.
We're not in the business of bullying people here. If you don't want to do it, you don't have to do it.
I can't apologise enough to the people who did go to the trouble of organising it without my knowledge.
We're still going to get some vision for our
Sam's the guy who can do it.
And Sam can talk with authority about coming into the chicane. Here's turn 8. This is problematic.
I know.
He can really give us some...
I mean, it might sound weird and disingenuous, but I do really loathe and despise, and there's a degree of self-recognition to this, but the sort of the look-at-me stylings of us in the media sometimes make me want to spew up as well. So that's part of it too.
Okay, let's check traffic. Thanks to Dutton's, experience the all-new Amarok with Dutton's extended test drive. Dutton's, easy to do business with.
Thanks, Will. Heavy showers last night, so take it easy on damp roads, particularly around the hills. Got lights on the blink this morning at Torrens Park, Blair Road near Springbank Road. Damaged barriers slowing things up at Matindi, Main North Road near Nottage Terrace. And look out for road closures around these parklands for the Adelaide 500. Lots of folk heading along this morning. Take it easy around Bartels Road and the Britannia Roundabout. Got a camera to Stonehouse Avenue, Camden Park. Drop everything and save on absolutely everything store-wide with Amart's Black Friday sale. Up to 60% off. Stores open at 8 a.m.
a.m. till late today. Hurry into Amart. T's and C's apply. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
5AA Mornings with Matthew Pantelis.
I think it's still an important message when cases go up. People need to be reminded of just the basics. Make sure you wash your hands.
Weekday mornings from 9.
I can't tell you the number of times recently, including at the cinema last night, where blokes have gone into the loo and then just walked straight out. I mean, I don't believe people do that still, but they do. I mean, basic hygiene, for goodness sake.
On 1395, Adelaide's 5AA. We understand not all small businesses are the same. That's why Nissan Fleet offers tailored vehicle solutions for your unique business needs. With dedicated fleet managers available across Australia, we're your local fleet experts, providing quality advice, support and customer service for the entire life of your vehicle fleet. Visit your local Nissan dealer or search Nissan Fleet today, and we'll find the right business solution for you.
Get great value Christmas gifts this Black Friday at Coles. Like selected gift cards from TCN, now 15% off. Redeemable at JB Hi-Fi and more. That's great value, hands down, at Coles. In-store only, excludes TCN variable load cards. Offer ends Tuesday, limits and T's and C's apply.
Parents, now you may have noticed your kids being suspiciously well-behaved lately. Maybe they're offering to mow the lawn, maybe to do the dishes, maybe they're offering to do the works.
It can only mean one thing. Santa's Wonderland is back this December. It's where Christmas begins.
Thousands of families flock like elves every year because just one ticket gets you 3 hours of unlimited Christmas fun.
Santa's Wonderland is packed with family fun, like three giant jumping castles, an ice skating rink, tobogganing, live stage shows, activities and 12 family-friendly carnival rides, plus an amazing 10-stop Christmas activity trail. There's no need to pay extra for rides once you're in. It's all included in your ticket.
Pre-purchase your tickets online and save. So don't miss Santa's Wonderland at the Adelaide Showground from December 1 to 24. Tickets on sale now, santaswonderland.com.au.
This Christmas will look a lot different for struggling families and vulnerable members of our community. The ongoing cost of living crisis makes it impossible to put a decent family meal on the table. And keeping a roof over their heads is getting harder and harder. People shouldn't be hungry, anxious and desperate this Christmas. Vinnies needs your help to give emergency support this Christmas. Head to vinnies.org.au or call 13 18 12 to donate.
Rosanna Mangiarelli here from 7 News. Join me and Will Goodings for Adelaide's leading news hour, 7 News, tonight at 6 o'clock.
Breakfast on 5AA, David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
If you're living with a disability, injury or health condition and looking for work, visit maxima.com.au.
24 after 7, 22 the expected top today. The good news is, given all the rain we had yesterday, there's less expected today. 2 to 10 mils expected today. 8, though, tomorrow. So it's shifted a bit until tomorrow. So it'll be 20 on Saturday. And then Sunday, pretty clear, cloudy, 21, very comfortable race conditions here. We were broadcasting live this morning, the Adelaide Velo 500 in the pit straight. You can watch along on the Foodland Supermarkets Facebook and YouTube live stream. Given the cold, though, a code blue has been issued for South Australia with the wet weather set to continue. It's unseasonably cool. If you look back, this time last year it was 28 on the Friday and 35 on the Saturday, so very different. It means people sleeping rough can call Homeless Connect SA on 1800 003 308 and find somewhere warm to stay while the wet weather continues. So you can the state government making preparations for people that are going to be sleeping rough. Let's turn our attention to sport and the sports show last night. $17 schnitty Monday to Wednesday at the Birkenhead Tavern, Excelsior and Lighthouse Wharf. You just know it's a Borough Hotel. Rowie was crook last night, but Timmy G caught up with the supercar drivers James Courtney and Cam Waters from Tickford Racing.
Finishing here in Adelaide, do you love the fact that it is the last race here in Adelaide and the fact that it sort of stacks up really nicely against the other events?
Yeah, for me, I reckon you guys have the best round of the season. I think for me it's a better race here, and typically when the sun's out.
Do our best.
So it's an awesome event. You guys put on a fantastic event here, and you know, I think the championship wasn't what it was when we missed out those few years. You know, it was always amazing when we started here, but you know, finishing here is just as good, and the best part is that we get to have a drink and enjoy Sunday night and the festivities in Adelaide on Sunday night and then into our gala on the Monday here.
Well, mate, we haven't had rain for about 4 months, so we're just going to get it out the way in the next 24 hours and then we're going to make it all nice sunshine for you to finish off with a great one.
Just as long as it's sunny on Monday when we're having a few drinks.
We'll make it happen for you, boys.
We'll do that for you. No dramas at all.
The sports show will be broadcasting live from down here at the Velo 500 to $17 Schnitty Monday to Wednesday, the Birkin Tavern, Excelsior and Lighthouse Wharf. You just know it's a bro hotel. This is something of a spectacle that we've got on behind us at the moment. You might be able to see it if you're on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook live
stream.
Yeah,
they'll be able to make that out.
But all the race control vehicles are lined up on the grid almost like they're going to have their own race off. So you've got...
So this is what Sam's going in on his own now on account of me being a massive blouse.
You can't say that anymore, David, of course.
Can't you?
No, because cowardice is non-gender specific. No, that's...
What if it... Can you say wuss?
Yes, you can say wuss.
Okay.
Yes.
I didn't know blouses on the ban list.
No, because it's just, you know...
Men can wear blouses, can't they?
Actually, you know what? You're probably right. You know what? I don't know what you can and can't say.
The whole world has
gone
mad.
You can't say anything these days.
To use the world whoriest
Lots
cliche.
Lots of Dutton's texts in support, though, David. You should not be self-deprecating. Love you, Dave. Furthest thing from being a wuss, says one. Philippa says, good on you, David. Admire your honesty and your explanation.
See, look at that car. That's clearly speeding. I've really come to the wrong event, haven't I?
I was just going to ask, you do know what happens here today, don't you? A little crowd gathering down near us as well here to watch the cars take off. Photographers, it is all crackling to life here.
I've got to say, the setup in here is second to none.
Yeah, it is, and it's well.
And it's interesting too, like how much national attention it's getting. Because like where we are, the pit stop. God, listen to those cars go. There's a whole swathe of people out the back, all looking, well and truly in the know. People who understand and follow the sport. Clearly, they're the ones you want covering it, I guess.
Exactly right. 28 after 7, 5AA News is coming up. Back with more shortly.
Dreaming of a new car? Now's the time to make it happen at Solitaire Volkswagen. With unbeatable deals on new and demonstrator vehicles in stock now and ready to drive away. Visit Solitaire Volkswagen, Hawthorne and Medindie today. DL 65541.
Since 1982, our passionate teams at First National Real Estate have worked 10,400 days and around 582 million hours across Australia with one common goal, to always put you first. And we'll be here in Adelaide to help you on your journey to your happy place. Be it a tree change, a sea change, upsize, downsize, or finding that investment gem. First National Real Estate. We put you first. firstnational.com.au.
Did you know that each year See Differently trains more guide and assistance dogs than any other organisation in South Australia? Now, we might see cute puppies, but they see much more. These gorgeous pups are life changers and, in some cases, life savers.
Now, it takes a dedicated team of staff and volunteers to train these heroes of tomorrow and literally costs tens of thousands of dollars.
Please donate generously to the See Differently. Do you see what I see? Christmas appeal and help more South Australians living with vision impairment to see what we see.
Go to seedifferently.org.au and donate today.
Selected Oztrak campers come with a wireless Bluetooth reverse camera, giving you a crystal clear view of everything behind you.
Tommy, I see you with those chucky bickies. Put five of those back, please.
Oztrak campers.
This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Showers easing in 22. With the 7:30 news, I'm Kendall Brantig.
Complete Windscreen supply and fit front, rear and door glass. Proudly South Australian since 1976.
There are calls for a royal commission into domestic violence after four women were allegedly murdered at the hands of their partners in SA in the past week. It comes as Kevin Jewell's body was found in the York Peninsula days after he shot and killed his estranged wife at their Modbury North home. Steph Mallon, who runs Village Co for women fleeing domestic violence, says enough is enough.
It can't just be up to an organisation or even a victim of domestic violence to make a change. We all need to use our voices and stand for this and stand for better outcomes and lives for women in our state.
Tomorrow, Rotary will hold a walk for respect from Victoria Square to King William Street starting at 9:30. There's been confirmation a four-day pause in fighting will soon come into effect in the Middle East. The agreement's expected to begin at 3:30 this afternoon our time, which will involve a comprehensive ceasefire in the north and south of Gaza. Israeli hostages and Palestinian prisoners are expected to be released. Israeli Defence Force spokesman Peter Lerner says the nation will still be on high alert.
They never seem to hold their fire. So we will be in defensive positions, holding our positions, making sure that we are well defended, well protected, but also very vigilant in case any attacks originate from Hamas, from the Gaza Strip, whether it's rockets or attacks against the forces on the ground.
Border Force is working to find out how a group of people reached Australian shores in a boat from Indonesia. 12 people were on board the vessel, which made land in a remote part of the Kimberley. It's not yet known whether they're seeking asylum. Nationals MP Barnaby Joyce says there's been a lack of attention on our borders.
Nobody wants this illegal trade in people to start up again. I hope that they work out how it happened and stop it. But you know, we've got to have a government that's on the front foot.
There's a push to expand government funding for early childhood education to improve access around the country. The Productivity Commission has released a draft report recommending every child get access to care for 3 days a week. It also wants accelerated pathways for childcare qualifications to boost workforce numbers. Early Childhood Minister Anne Alley says the federal government will carefully consider the findings.
This is only a draft report, but what it does confirm is what the research tells us, that access to early childhood education and care not only benefits children, but that it also benefits the economy because it allows parents to be able to go to work or go to study.
Aussies aren't buying new underwear, and experts say it's indicative of a failing economy. The US owner of bonds has singled out the Australian market as being very difficult, with sales plunging in the past year. Dr. Eloise Zoppers from Monash University says men's underwear sales in particular are the canary in the coal mine.
It's a little known effect that's colloquially known as the men's underwear index. And a lot of studies in economics and marketing have showed that when men's underwear sales slow down, it can be indicative of a recession because people are spending less on certain items and men's underwear seems to be one of them.
And it's Black Friday, so a good opportunity to get some new underwear. Westfield Marion, Tea Tree Plaza and Westlakes will be open through till 9 tonight, while Harbour Town's holding a 13-hour shopping marathon and Rundle Mall is Black Friday Central in the city. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Gliderol Garage Doors new Platinum and Native Series sectional doors are here. Gliderol.com.au.
Here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Kendall. Soggy conditions are expected again today for the Adelaide 500, with qualifying to begin around lunchtime today. Brody Kostecki leads the championship, but Shane Van Gisbergen is still a chance to take it from him. Let's go to cricket. A brilliant Josh Inglis century hasn't been enough to help Australia to a win against India in the first of their T20 matches. Inglis smashed 110 off only 50 balls as the Aussies made 3 for 208, but the home side chased it down with a ball to spare. Well, day two of the Australian PGA Championship is underway in Queensland, and veteran Rod Pampling is one of the early movers with 2 birdies. That now puts him at 5 under, and he's now just 3 shots off the lead. To football, Adelaide draftee Oscar Ryan has spoken of his surprise at being selected by the Crows. The wingman, who hails from Victoria, was taken at pick 27, and he's told Rowan Timmy G he couldn't believe it when his name was called.
Oh, it was a massive shock. I was going down with Connor as the plus one and ended up getting my name read out, luckily enough.
Rugby legend David Campese has put his hand up to coach the Wallabies. Rugby Australia has begun the search for a new mentor after Eddie Jones walked away after a disastrous World Cup campaign. Campese telling Wild World of Sports he's available to take over.
Oh, I'd love to, mate, but I don't think that there's a possibility. Who knows? But I've, you know, what I've got is knowledge. After 15 years for Australia, mate, I've got a lot of knowledge, a lot of skills.
And finally, Sam Kerr is on the score sheet again for Chelsea. Her side now locked at 1-1 against Paris FC. That's in their Champions League match this morning. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Now to the traffic.
Reimagine your home, elevate your life at 88 O'Connell Street Luxury Apartments. See 88oconnell.com.
Heavy showers last night, so take it easy on damp roads this morning. Look out for lights on the blink at Torrens Park, Blair Road at Springbank Road. Damage barrier at Medindie today, Main North Road near Nottage Terrace, speeds at 40 and slow through the East Parklands with those road closures for the Adelaide 500. Look out for lots of folk heading along today. You'll find Cameron's, Anzac Highway, Plimpton and Everard Avenue at Keswick. The sound of you enjoying a delicious barista-made coffee from OTR. Pop in and get your pick-me-up now at OTR. Making life easy. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Stay cool. Service your aircon at Automasters. And keep cool with Cool Now, Pay Later options.
Showers easing today, a high of 22. Showers tomorrow, 20. Cloudy on Sunday, 21. And more of the same for Monday, 20. At the moment, 16. More news as it happens on 5AA.
With help from Fluorio Milk Company and the Udder Way, cafes all over Adelaide have joined the fight to reduce plastic waste. Instead of single-use plastic bottles, they've introduced the Udder Way's reusable 18-litre kegs. In the initial week, they stand to eliminate 1,500 plastic bottles. Together with other cafes, supermarkets, schools, restaurants, hotels and workplaces, millions of single-use plastic bottles will be taken out of circulation. You gotta feel good about that. Visit fluoriomilkco.com.au for more.
The Renault Black Friday event is on from the 13th to the 27th of November. Get your driveway looking its best for summer and drive away in an eye-catching Renault SUV. Visit your Renault dealer to book a test drive today.
Renault. 5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube.
Breakfast on 5AA, David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
If you're living with a disability, injury or health condition and looking for work, visit maxima.com.au.
If you're anywhere near a computer or a device, jump on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream, because right now Sam Daddo is on a lap around the track here at the Adelaide Velo 500 in one of the race control vehicles. Sam, have we got you? Are you on the move?
Yeah, boys, I'm already coming up to turn five, so we have got a little bit of pace going on. We're heading up towards Hutt Street now. Jeez, I'm not too sure. We're in a little Hyundai, but it moves quite a bit, which is nice. Coming up to turn seven, so turn seven is up towards Peary Street. We're on Hutt Street now as we brake hard into the right-hander, and then it's on the back straight. The fearsome turn eight, which claims a lot of drivers. If you jump on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream, you'll see we have actually got a decent pace up, about 140-ish into the back straight. Turn 8 as we approach on the brakes at about 150 metre mark, easing it up, dipping it into turn 8, hitting the ripple strip nicely as we head down to the old Britannia roundabout. Of course, the Britannia roundabout isn't in service this afternoon, thank goodness for that. Turn 9, we come back onto Wakefield Street as we turn right, and this is the bit that's, of course, the old Formula 1 track as well, so nice bit of ripple strip as we come out of turn 9. Through to 10, back into the old Victoria Park racecourse. So we're back into the parkland section of the circuit. Shout out to Jane Lomax-Smith for the car race this weekend. But as we head back up to turn 4, back on the parklands, how good is this joint? This place is world class. And it head towards turn 14, the hairpin, as we come back onto the pitch straight. And that is a 5AA breakfast. Hot lap live of the Velo Adelaide 500 circuit.
Can you so, wave to us as you go past?
I don't know how it came up on the live stream, brilliant. But geez, that was all right. I'm that coming up moment. Right
the
now.
Is you know all the, and all the turns and everything.
Yeah, exactly. And I might just quickly just grab.
Number, is that you?
Yeah, that's me, mate. And I might just quickly grab a comment from, what was your name? Sorry, you actually took me on the track.
Yeah, Rob.
How many years have you been working at the Velo 500?
Since the very first one, the Sensational Adelaide 500. I was here at the start and all the Grand Prix before that.
And what's your main job here, other than taking rev heads like me for a hot lap?
Look after the course car during the day, open and closing laps, check things during the day, and generally have a good time.
I had a good time. Thanks, mate. Really appreciate it. Back to you, David and Will.
Thank you, Sam. Magnificent
awesome,
work.
Sam.
That was the role he was born to play. I mean,
it was.
No one knows the track better than Sam Daddo, who's gone to every Bathurst for about 20 years. He obviously comes to the Adelaide 500 every year. He's a massive supercars fan. We were just remarking, too, it's a hell of a lot of fun to see. There's a lot of people out on the track taking laps in the race cars. The race.
So these are like the hardcore fans who are out there who they've arranged to get in there.
They've got rides in the race control vehicles, which are varied. I mean, there's people jumping in utes going around.
Yeah, there's some old ute. Looks like an old 1950 Chevy ute or something.
Looks superb. There's a
Sam's got a smile on his face from one ear to the other.
The Hyundai that Sam was in is just behind us here. There was a Mustang going around before.
It's a good thing, too, that they have closed Britannia Roundabout, because the last thing you'd want as a supercar driver would be to have some, you know, like a Kensington Gardens granny just pulling out at 20 kilometres an hour off to have coffee with the girls somewhere on the parade. That'd be... some recently arrived Uber driver.
I disagree. I think you think you're a world-class driver. Well, let's see you negotiate the Britannia Roundabout.
I actually think it's probably harder to negotiate still than a lot of the turns here.
Completely.
Don't you think?
Absolutely.
Well, how
many things? I can tell you.
One, two, there's five roads feeding into it.
It's rare that you negotiate the Britannia Roundabout and it's Shane Van Gisbergen in the other lane. Tends to be someone who's significantly less capable of driving.
Who invented the Britannia Roundabout? Is there some sort of old, sort of 1930s black and white portrait up at Dipty of this guy who looks like Alfred E. Newman? You know, the inventor of the Britannia Roundabout. It really is a total bloody disaster, that thing.
I think its reputation's worse than what it is. And that's what gets people.
Not.
It's because people get so anxious with, like, oh, now it's the... People do roundabouts all the time.
But heaps of people will never use it.
Yeah, I know.
I know people who will drive all the way down to, you know, Portrush Road to avoid using it.
It's better since they did the dual Britannia.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
That's improved it a bit. 18-2-8, let's take some meat tray Friday calls. We're talking to you about your registration on your vehicle. Have you had any that are notable, memorable, funny, or... things you just had it developed an affinity for. We've got Dimitri, thanks to Corinthian Meats, Peter and Harry.
We love Corinthian Meats.
Give away before 9 o'clock this morning. Let's go to Michael first. Michael, good morning to you.
Yeah, good morning, boys. Going back 2 years ago, I loaned some money to a tenant of mine. She bolted on me. I had no way of getting the money back. Legal advice said, no, you're not going to get your money back. So I got gutted. So I thought... my only form of retribution was to, I fashioned a number plate identical to, you know, an authentic South Australian number plate with the word scumbag and front and back. And, you know, I made the model of it and, it looked absolutely perfect with my intention just to put it on the front and back of a number plate and, you know, I'm not going to get... I wasn't going to get my money back, but I was going to get some payback. Anyway, I practice fitted it on my vehicle I was all set for the next day. Anyway, I got to work and I parked in the car park and one of my workmates walked up to me and said, what's going on here, mate? I'd forgotten to take the scumbag number plate off my own vehicle.
Oh, no.
That's mate.
And I'd driven to work. Yeah, I'd driven to work with the company logo on my vehicle and scumbag and,
Yeah, that's a tough one to explain. Thank you. Thank you, Michael.
Fantastic.
Let's go to Andrew from Craigmore. Morning, Andrew.
G'day, guys. It's a culture vulture from Craigmore here. I'd like to say hello to Will and Ayrton Penberthy there.
Thank you, mate.
His racing car. I've had a couple cars. My first car was UXB. Remember the series Unexploded Bomb?
Oh, yeah, Danger UXB with the British soldiers going around defusing bombs.
UXB, 00-something. And then I had a beautiful yellow panel van, and that is SMG, So Many Girls, with a couple of other numbers.
No
and
need
then
to brag.
My latest, pardon?
No need to brag.
Mate, I've only ever had one, and it's still with me. Don't know why, but... and then I've got my last one, which is my Pajero, and it's got Splash, and I've had that for years, and I got that because I was up at our on-site caravan, and I fell out of my boat. I come in dripping like a wet rat, and my clever mate said, well, it didn't take us long to find a name for you. Your nickname's now Splash.
Terrific, mate.
Good stuff, Andrew. Thank you.
You don't want to know what Pajero means in Spanish, but we'll save that for another day.
Let's
Pajero, it's pronounced.
Let's go to Bellevue Heights. Kayleen, we'll take one more before the break. Kayleen, good morning.
Good morning. I had one guy come up to me and he said, oh, are you from Wales? Are you Welsh? And I said, no. what are you looking at? And he said, your number plate. It's CMYMR2.
Do you know how you pronounce that in Welsh? Is it Simru? How do you say it?
I don't know, but he thought it was Welsh, but it's not. It's C, my MR2. My car's an MR2.
Oh. I can see how the confusion arose, Kayleen. Good one. Thank you. CYMR2.
How do you say it in Welsh?
I don't know.
But most of those things...
Surely, we can get a Welsh listener to ring up. How do you say CYMRU, which is how Wales is spelt in Welsh? But how do you say it?
Give us a call right now, 822-3000 if you can tell us. Otherwise, we're going to go to check traffic. Thanks to Keys. Are tired of back pain? We'll try Keys at kieser.com.au.
Thanks, Will. The odd damp road from overnight showers. Take it easy in the drive-in. Look out for lights on the blink today at Torrens Park, Ballina Road at Springbank Road. Damaged barrier slowing things up at Bedindi at the moment. Main North Road near Nottage Terrace. And in these parklands, lots of folks heading along to the Adelaide 500 today. Look out for them around to Kettleville Terrace and Britannia Roundabout. Got a camera to Wood Street at Millswood. Westfield Week of Offers is on. Open till 9 tonight with giveaways, entertainment and huge savings centre-wide. Head into Westfield Marion, Tea Tree Plaza and West Lakes now. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Shane Lynch was just 13 when his parents found dirty magazines under his bed. I mean, they were filthy, covered in concrete, dust and muck. Copies of Dreamy Driveways and Concrete Connoisseur. This fetish later gave birth to Adelaide Exposed Concrete. Highly skilled professionals dedicated to pouring perfect concrete paths, sheds and exposed aggregate driveways. AdelaideExposedConcrete.com.au. Best on ground all year round.
If you need to fix your pipes, call Precise.
Call Precise.
If your toilet's blocking up, call Precise.
Call Precise.
If your lights aren't turning on, or your hot water is gone, or a plumber or an electrician, call Precise.
Precise.
Precise Plumbing and Electrical. Call 1300 700 200. That's 1300 700 200. Precise Plumbing and Electrical. Local and experienced trade specialists.
Or a plumber or an electrician, call Precise.
Call Precise.
Now, Will, what could be better than Black Friday at Toolkit Depot?
Well, how about 8 Black Fridays in a row?
Now, that's going to do it for sure.
Your Toolkit Depot's Black Friday sale is on now with 8 days of cracking deals.
From November 24 to 26, buy a Milwaukee M18 Fuel 2-piece power pack and get a bonus Milwaukee angle grinder valued at $418 and get an instant 5-amp bonus battery.
Or buy an M18 Fuel 6-piece power pack, get a bonus Milwaukee rotary hammer drill. That's valued at $499 and get 2 instant bonus 5-amp batteries.
Visit any one of the 5 Toolkit Depot stores across SA, open 7 days a week, or visit toolkitdepot.com.au. Toolkit Depot's Black Friday sale on now until November 27.
I was just doing my job. I didn't think I'd get injured.
The doctor said it was a routine procedure. Right.
The car came out of nowhere and it smashed right into us.
At DBH Lawyers, we're here to listen to your story. Our team of local South Australian lawyers will help you navigate the law and find the best way forward. We're with you. We're for you. We're DBH Lawyers. DBH.com.au.
G'day, it's Rory Sloan for Jarvis Toyota. The new and improved Hilux Rogue is wider, taller and tougher. The 2.8-litre turbo diesel engine pumps out 150 kilowatts of effortless power, enough to cruise through the work week and power into the weekend. Hilux Rogue is loaded with enhancements for on- and off-road performance. Check out the new Hilux Rogue for yourself today at Jarvis Toyota, South Road, Clovelly Park. Proudly celebrating 21 years of great deals.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube.
Breakfast on 5AA, David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
Jobs, apprenticeships, traineeships and careers. Maxima can help. Learn more today at maxima.com.au.
10 minutes to 8, broadcasting live this morning from the trackside at the Velo Adelaide 500, which you can catch glimpses of cars going past and all sorts of things happening. If you're watching along the Foodland Supermarkets Facebook and YouTube live stream.
It looks like the set of A Touch of Elegance a bit here. I've got the sporting the cross-legged look here. Just wait, it almost needs Sir Les Patterson to rock up. A touch of bloody elegance, ladies and gentlemen.
What's a smaller unit of elegance than a touch?
A skerrick
of elegance.
A soussant.
What about the total absence of elegance?
Oh, that could be dearth of elegance.
A dearth of elegance. I like that.
A bugger all of elegance.
I tell you what, you look at the rain we've had in the last 24 hours, and the Bureau's map tells a pretty intriguing story. And it tells a story where we overshot the forecast by a long, long way. Western suburbs had somewhere in the order of 20 mils, if you're looking around Glenelg and the airport yesterday, since 9 a.m. this is, so over that period. Out north, Port Adelaide, 15. Get further north, Elizabeth, 14, 15. Tea Tree Gully had around 20. The hills and foothills got it most. Woodside had about 23. You get up towards Birdwood, 24, 27 if you go ever so slightly north. The area around Harndorf had about 20. And down south, in the range of 19, 16. If you go all the way down to Noarlunga, they got about 19 mils there. 16 in Echunga if you're coming east. So it was a stack of rain on the way. We probably won't get that much again in the next 24 hours. It's about 10 mils forecast. So
I thought that was the rain that was coming today.
Well, I think it was originally, I think. That
so
was,
I'll tell you, he's feeling a bit vindicated by all this, and that's Mate Abraham.
Well, he was scathing of the Weather Bureau yesterday, wasn't he? And I think he may have even done a victory lap on our texts. Not the text line, but just the private text.
He wouldn't do a victory lap here. He's like me. He's a nerdy old fart like me.
He didn't know. He hasn't done a victory lap that way.
No need for... Hey, carry on the road.
A pretty interesting last 24 hours for the ice arena. Now, this story took a couple of twists. It was announced yesterday that the ice arena was going to shut up shop for the foreseeable future because of financial problems. And there was a host of sporting clubs that used the arena, ice hockey teams, ice skaters, and others who had said, well, we've just got the call, training's all off. We can't do what we do there anymore. They went to the media and said, well, it's not like having a footy field that closes and we just go to another one. There is no other
ice.
You
can't really play ice hockey anywhere else in Adelaide, can you?
Have a listen to Christian Knott from Ice Hockey SA.
Imagine an AFL team that can't train before it, or cricket. The Adelaide Oval is the only place we can play cricket and there's nowhere to do it. It is our one thing, and without that, we can't really go and play ice hockey anywhere else.
But there was some good news late yesterday. Managing director of the ice arena, Richard Laidlaw, spoke to 10 News First and says it should actually reopen next week with new management.
All things going well, I expect that ice arena should be open for business middle of next week. Which we're then going to do a great big relaunch and offer a great incentive, which is free skating for a whole week here at Ice Arena. So we're going to invite all of Adelaide to have a skate.
So it's been sold and bought within the space of a fortnight?
Yeah, it seems to be that way. Yeah, there's new management arrangements being put in place in a very short period of time, which is great news for all the people that do use it and rely on it. Excellent story.
It's a really popular place for kids' birthdays. And I know a lot of kids with disabilities go there as well. It's good for developing, like, coordination and stuff like that. Not that I've ever managed to do it. Can you ice skate well?
I got laughed off the ice in London when everyone bullied me into doing it, and I warned them about how
in London?
It. Yeah, over Christmas in 2019. And everyone's like, we'll get a nice photo. And I said, no, we won't. We're going to get a near-miss accident that's going to take place. And so I shuffled out there, and this lovely English woman was trying to explain to me how simple it is to ice skate. By saying, it's like sweeping the floor. And she kept saying, it's like sweep the floor with your feet. And she looked at me and said, have you never swept the floor before?
Well, no. Well, the answer to that is probably no.
Well, she may have had a point.
If you were going to do a routine, what would your piece of music be, do you think? If you were, you know, going down the Torval and Dean type path. What was that? They used Ravel's Bolero, didn't they? Oh, no, that was someone else. Oh, no, it wasn't. No, I think they used Ravel's Bolero.
Probably something by... Do you have to use classical music?
No, you can use any music you want.
You can use any music you like.
What about It's Hip to Be Square by Hugh Lewis and the News?
All right,
That'd be all right.
Let's go with that.
That'd be a good one to dance to on the ice.
Hey, we received a text about this yesterday on the Dutton's text line, and I had multiple people stop me over the course of the day and say, I can't hear what wait to hear what David says about this. And so I thought we should play it today. It actually comes out of a conversation we had yesterday about the Reserve Bank Governor, Michelle Bullock, who was making the point that no longer is inflation a byproduct of international pressures, which we've been able to say for so long. War in Ukraine, post-COVID slosh of money that's knocking around the global economy. She said, no, this is now an Australian problem. Have you heard the sorts of things she said Australians are doing that are adding to inflation?
What, eating food and stuff?
Have a listen.
Hairdressers, dentists, dining out, sporting and other recreational activities. The prices of all these services are rising strongly. The remaining inflation challenge we're dealing with is increasingly homegrown and demand-driven.
Demand-driven.
So the, the implication is... demand for things like...
Going to the dentist.
Getting rid of tooth decay. Maybe having dinner. Dining out. So you're not allowed to go to your local pub to buy a modestly priced countery for your wife and kids on a Friday night. Stay home and, you know, when it comes to dental pain, just smear a bit of Bongella on the old chompers and don't go to the... Like, these people are living off in some rarefied Martin Place, heads up their fundament world. They've got no... And I know you've made a valiant effort to say, oh, she's doing this for the greater good.
I knew that.
But yet again,
yeah.
Like they've got no common touch. Mm. Never have. Reserve Bank governors over the years have had so many attempts at explaining or sympathising with the average punter, and they've failed every time.
The idea that people are just living high on the hog by going to the dentist is a new one.
Yeah. Oh, you know, you seen her, she just got a filling.
Yeah.
Here comes Lord Muck with his filling.
That is outrageous. It's tough to talk about the pronunciation of written words on radio because you need to have seen them. But there's the someone in our discussion about license plate numbers had, in fact, the Welsh spelling for the name Wales. And they were asked, are you Welsh? And it turned out, no, it was just... it was another plate that was personalised for them with no knowledge of actually what it was. And then we realised we had no idea how to say the word. John in Shido Park, though, I think you can help us out. John, good morning.
Yeah, good morning, guys. How you going?
Good, mate. How do you say
it? You say it clumry.
Clumry.
Clumry, as in C-L-U-M-R-E-E. Clumry is how it's pronounced.
Clumry.
Clumry.
Yep.
Well, that's excellent. It's spelt
nothing like that, but that's how it's pronounced.
So, John, your background's obviously Welsh, or are you just a good language guy?
Not really. No, not really. My background is Scottish, but my mum's Welsh, so...
Some Welsh words just bear no relation to what we expect them to sound like.
Yucky da.
Exactly.
Yucky da.
Yeah, well...
That's what you say
for really
cheers, isn't
very
it?
Very much. Yeah, I think you do, yeah. I know
Sorry, John. No, okay. Let's give John a 5AA breakfast mug for helping us
out.
Let's
do it.
We appreciate our listeners that come up with their expertise.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thank
you. Geez, they're good people, the Welsh. Isn't it such a beautiful accent?
It is. Have you seen the...
Rob Brydon.
Have you seen the Disney show...
Harriet, the chef? Really hard to do the Welsh accent, but it's incredibly sort of rich and layered.
Ryan Reynolds and Rob McElhenney. Ryan Reynolds, of course, is a huge Canadian movie star. Rob McElhenney was behind the show Always Sunny in Philadelphia, but bought a Welsh football side by the name of the Wrexham Football Club.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's the subject of a documentary they've been making over the years now, because their view is they want to get it from the doldrums of English football, playing in the National League, up through League 2, League 1 Championship, to the Premier League one day, ideally, because they have oodles of money.
Mm.
They can support it. The best thing about that show is the insight it gives you into the Welsh people and the Welsh mentality. And it's all about telling the stories of the publicans in the area and the people that followed their team their whole lives and people that used to work. They moved there because of the mining. 60 years ago, but now they define new industries to work in. It is a great story about Welsh people that's dressed up as this Hollywood people by football team, but that's not really what it's about. I think it's really well done and worth checking out. It's on Disney.
Made a big people contribution to Australia, the Welsh.
Absolutely. 5AA News is coming up. We'll be back with more from the Velo Adelaide 500 shortly.
Dreaming of a new car? Now's the time to make it happen at Solitaire Volkswagen. With unbeatable deals on new and demonstrator vehicles in stock now and ready to drive away. Visit Solitaire Volkswagen, Hawthorne and Medindi today. DL 65541.
Energy providers are still emptying your wallet, but the good news is that now it's cheaper to generate your own electricity using solar and batteries. NRG Solar's expertise can guide you to owning your energy sooner. As a trusted retailer, they provide you with top-tier solar battery technology, complete with a 10-year warranty, blackout protection, and user-friendly apps for ultimate control. Fight back with NRG Solar and take charge of your electricity. Visit nrgsolar.com.au today.
online, on DAB Digital Radio, and on 1395 AM. Talking Adelaide. This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Showers easing in 22. With the 8 o'clock news, I'm Kendall Brettig.
Chipped windscreen? Complete Windscreens can repair it from just $99. Look for the big red koala.
Advocates and families of domestic violence victims are calling for a royal commission after four women were allegedly murdered at the hands of their partner this week in SA. There are calls for more funding, help and education about DV through our schools and workplaces. Steph Mallon, who runs the Village Co and helps those fleeing violence, says it's time for men to step up and be part of the solution too.
They need to stand up and be a really good example for their mate who might be struggling, to be a good example for boys in the community, in their families.
Tomorrow, Rotary's holding a Walk for Respect parade from Victoria Square to King William Street starting at 9:30. The temporary ceasefire between Israel and Hamas will start at 3:30 this afternoon our time. The pause in fighting will last 4 days, with 13 women and child hostages to be released on the first day and handed over to the Red Cross. Qatari Foreign Ministry spokesman Dr. Majid Al Ansari says the meetings with foreign leaders were very positive.
The result, of course, was the implementation plan of the agreement, which we have always said needed to be something that is concrete and very ready to create a safe environment for the release of the hostages.
Palestinian prisoners are also expected to be freed. There's a push for a major funding boost to make childcare more accessible around the nation. More from Zach De Silva in Canberra.
The Productivity Commission says all families should be able to access early childhood education at least 3 days a week. In a draft report, the economic advisory body's urging the federal government to provide extra support in communities where there aren't enough commercial childcare operators. The commission's also calling for greater subsidies for lower income families to make care more affordable. Labor says it's already making progress on some of the recommendations. The final report is due mid-next year.
Australia's banks are joining forces to launch ScamSafe software to increase customer security. The ScamSafe Accord involves a range of significant measures. $100 million is being invested in developing a new confirmation of the payee system. Consumers are expected to spend billions of dollars over the next 4 days in Black Friday and Cyber Monday deals. The sale period is fast becoming one of the most significant events on the calendar for Australian retailers. SA businesses are expected to turn over around $400 million. National Retail Association Director Rob Godwin says it's a welcome boost for business owners after a lean year.
They are looking at flat year-on-year sales. This cyber period gives them opportunity to clear some stock. So from the retailer's perspective, it gives them the necessary income to support them during this last quarter of the calendar year.
It seems the ice arena has been saved. Yesterday it was announced Adelaide's only ice rink would be closing, with the former operator facing financial difficulties. But it'll be reopening next week under new management. And there are fears over a mysterious outbreak of a respiratory illness in China, with the World Health Organization urgently requesting more details. Alison Petrowski reports.
The World Health Organization has made a formal request for more data from Chinese officials after an uptick in cases of pneumonia in children. In a statement, the WHO says it is unclear if these are associated with the overall increase in respiratory infections previously reported by Chinese authorities or separate events. Videos posted on social media by Chinese citizens appear to show crowded pediatric wards in hospitals in the north of the country. Though experts say more data is needed, there is no indication that the outbreak poses any global threat.
Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Gliderol Garage Doors, adding strength, safety and style to South Australian homes for over 40 years. Gliderol.com.au.
Here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Kendall. Chas Mostert has clocked the quickest time in practice at the Adelaide 500 in rainy conditions. All eyes will be on championship contenders Brody Kostecki and Shane Van Gisbergen, but the pair finished well down the timesheet in the opening practice session. Meantime, Mercedes Formula One star Lewis Hamilton is denying Red Bull's claim he approached them about a move earlier this year. Let's go to cricket. In the opening T20 match between Australia and India, Josh Inglis became the fifth Aussie to score a T20 international 100. India just got over the line, however, to win the match by 2 wickets. Aussie captain Matthew Wade says despite the loss, there were still positives to come out of the match.
I thought we bowled pretty well. Jason Berendorf was terrific for us, and young Sanger to keep us in the game and get wickets when they were going after him, I think was really important. 4 more games to go, so hopefully we can get on the board soon.
Audio there, thanks to Fox. Meantime, former West Indies batter Marlon Samuels has been handed a 6-year ban from all cricket for breaching anti-corruption rules in the Abu Dhabi T20 League in 2019. To golf now, Spaniard Joel Moscatel Nashon is still the man to catch early on day two. That's in the Australian PGA Championship at Royal Queensland. Now, he won't tee off until this afternoon and is at 8-under. Putting him 1 shot clear of Minwoo Lee, who's also set to tee off later this morning at 7-under. Meantime, talks are heating up that world number 3 John Rahm could be headed to the LIV Tour. The 2-time major champion is one of the biggest names on the PGA Tour. And in some soccer to finish, Sam Kerr is on fire for Chelsea in their Champions League clash against Paris FC. She's already scored a hat-trick. There's about 20 minutes to play, and they currently lead 3-1. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Now onto the traffic.
Reimagine your home, elevate your life at 88 O'Connell Street Luxury Apartments. See 88oconnell.com.
Heavy showers last night, so take it easy on damp roads this morning. And Torrens Park, traffic lights aren't on Blair Road and Springbank Road. Mindindee, damaged barrier, main north road near Nottage Terrace, speeds at 40. And in the East Parklands, road closures continue for the Adelaide 500. Lots of people around to Kettleville Terrace and Bartels Road at the moment, heading in for the event. Got a camera setting up right now, main north road at Mawson Lakes. Harris Garth's Black Friday sale is on now. Get 70% off Casa Domani Corello Sand. 16-piece coupe dinner set. Exclusions apply. Harris Garth, great brands, great prices. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Stay cool. Service your aircon at Automasters. And keep cool with Cool Now, Pay Later options.
Showers easing in 22 today, showers tomorrow 20, cloudy on Sunday 21, and more of the same for Monday 20. At the moment 16. More news as it happens on 5AA.
I was just doing my job. I didn't think I'd get injured.
The doctor said it was a routine procedure? Right.
The car came out of nowhere and it smashed right into us.
At DBH Lawyers, we're here to listen to your story. Our team of local South Australian lawyers will help you navigate the law and find the best way forward. We're with you. We're for you. We're DBH Lawyers. dbh.com.au.
Oh, you know, would it be great to have in an Austrac camper? A wireless phone charger. Just a sec.
Yeah, mate.
What's that? Austrac campers already have wireless phone chargers? Oh, yeah. No, I'll tell them.
Austrac. It's Black Friday weekend this weekend at Cheapest Chimps with fantastic deals to help you live cheaper. This Friday only, you get a Blaupunkt 55-inch 4K Ultra HD HD TV with built-in Chromecast and Google Assist for only $499. You save $200 on that one. They've also got the Pent Metal Shed for $249, save $100.
And pick up stick vacuum cleaners for just $99. Then from Saturday to Monday only, you can get 25% off all white goods. That's 25% off the Germanica tumble dryer and washing machine, or the coveted Germanica chest freezer, great for storing all those Christmas leftovers.
But they've also got 25% off all toys to get you sorted for Christmas, and up to 50% off genuine Adidas men's shoes.
There's many more amazing Black Friday weekend deals at Cheapest Chips. Grab their Black Friday catalogue or check it out online and live cheaper with Cheapest Chips.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head to 5AA on Facebook or YouTube. Yesterday was
your last day. Breakfast on 5AA, David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
Jobs, apprenticeships, traineeships and careers. Maxima can help. Learn more today at maxima.com.au.
10 minutes after 8, I didn't think you need me to set it up any longer. We're at the Velo Adelaide 500 where the Porsche Carrera Cup practice session is underway. First racing on track today. The gates are open. People are beginning to trickle in. I don't know to which degree it's coming through via our microphones, but to sit here right now,
I think it's audible.
It's hard to hear yourself think. I tell you what, there's an element to motorsport, the people that go regularly that talk about, that those that don't, it's hard to quantify until you see it yourself. But there's such a vast difference between seeing the power and speed of a vehicle live in person compared to on a TV screen. Yeah. On a TV screen, you get no context and you know they're going fast. To sit here on pit straight and see these Porsches go past,
the interesting thing too is my understanding is that most of these drivers are also obstetricians, which is how they got the cars. Big shout out to our good mate Chris Sexton there.
It's, if you notice, actually, they hug the wall across pit straight because they've been told to leave clear a space that they say is Kluger affected, where the track, it's just not race conditions because someone drove their Kluger on
here
just before 6 o'clock this morning as they come past again.
Those cars actually do look pretty amazing.
Oh, it's just phenomenal.
The way they just sort of, you know, sit so low.
You, I mean, whether you're a fan of the sport or not, the engineering behind it, the science that goes into it, and then the skill of driving the cars, it's truly a... It's an incredible sport.
How fast will they be going? What do you reckon, Sam? 200? 220 Ks?
180-ish, probably. 170.
You reckon? No, it looks like more than that.
Oh, I don't know.
So, this is the Porsche Carrera Cup's on now, and this is the beauty of it. It's not... If you come down to the Velo, and you're not just watching supercars all day. You're watching your Porsches now. You've got the GTs that will be on just after 8:30 this morning. And you build up over the course of the day and see different classifications of vehicle. One just come out of the pits behind us. You get a good look at this one on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream. The OTR car had Shaheen written on the site. Is it driven by a Shaheen? I was going to say, that's the driver's name. It is too. Sam Shaheen driving. We just saw him. Maybe that's why he came by to say hi to everyone watching on the 5AA.
Grab a coffee and on the run.
He's going to go a Mose. He's going to go a Mose.
Do the high bit.
On the track.
Go a Mose. I love that ad.
Okay, sure to do some texts.
It won an award, that ad.
On the for Meat Tray Friday, thanks to the great people at Corinthian Meats, where this morning we're asking you about number plates, whether you've had one that's meant something to you, funny, silly, just a fluke of numbers that you grew great affectionate for. We've got a few coming through now.
Yeah, a few suggestions here as to what Will's ice skating routine song should be. One here suggesting Pump Up the Jam, best routine song ever. Mick said it should be Vanilla Ice's Ice Ice Baby. One here about the Reserve Bank governors tut-tutting about the fact that Australians are apparently splurging in a profligate way on things like dentistry and having the occasional restaurant meal. W writes, I can't afford to eat out or go to the dentist. So she's doing her bit there. Scott from Modbury calling me a massive wuss now that we've retired the word blouse. Morning, boys. One of the funniest things you'll ever see is Darryl Waltrip's Bathurst hot lap. Should take a cup of concrete, Pembo, and give us the Adelaide version. Sorry, Scott, I passed. Quite a few people said good on me for not doing it. In case you weren't listening, I, being a bit of a pansy, said I wasn't going to be going around in the car and that Sam could do that. So, yeah, not really, I guess, on my part, reading the mood of the event. But nevertheless, it's a good natural segue to today's Breaking at 8 as well.
All right, well, let's...
If you'd like to make that sound for me, Will.
Well, we should get to Breaking at 8 before the cars come around because we're going to struggle to hear when it ends otherwise. So let's go to Breaking at 8.
Well, today's Breaking It Out is actually about road safety, funnily enough. Now, with the new Women's and Children's Hospital being built there in the western part of the parklands behind the RA, one thing that is going to be a casualty of that is the Road Safety Centre, where a lot of kids learn all about the road rules, younger drivers, young cyclists go and learn how to, you know, behave on roundabouts and with traffic lights and so forth. So it's going to get shut down. Apparently there's an announcement imminent about where the new road safety centre is going to be. And apparently it's going to be down near the old Marineland site at West Beach. Now there's plans that have been drawn up for it. I think the announcement about it was actually delayed this week, probably because of the terrible focus on road safety on account of what happened to young Charlie. But an announcement is going to be made pretty soon about the new location, and you would hope that it is as big and as educational as the existing one, which has served young South Australians so well, teaching them how to remain safe on the roads.
I think one way or another, everyone's gone through the Road Safety Centre at some point in their life, haven't they?
We used to be at Oaklands. Yeah. Used to be on Oaklands Road opposite the old Metro Twin Drive-In.
When did it move?
I reckon it moved in about 1990.
Yeah, I reckon I went to that one, the original one.
Yeah, I did. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. When I would have been
in primary
school.
It was massive, that one.
Yeah.
I think a lot of that land has been sold off, though, hasn't it? There's still the creek that runs through there.
Yeah.
And a nice playground, too.
All right. It's...
It'll get the earplugs.
Well, the good news is, coming through the microphone, I think people listening at home say it sounds magnificent. You just hear the faint din of vehicles in the background. That's the testament to the quality of the technology we're working with.
Well,
because exactly. I can't hear a damn thing otherwise. It's just fantastic. Sorry, I was just got distracted. Sam Shaheen's just come around again. He just heard around the corner. In fact, he's coming down Pitt Street as we speak right now. There he goes. Wow. Go Amos.
Go Amos.
16 after 8. We're going to some more Metro Friday entries in just a moment. And looking forward to this, if you are a race fan, Sam Daddo is going to do his best Martin Brundle impersonation and go down in front of the at the back of the paddock where all the drivers and the teams congregate and knock around. Local celebrities, who knows? He's going to be out there describing the action for us right after the break. Let's check traffic. Thanks to Keyser. Are you tired of back pain? Try Keyser, Keyser.com.au.
Thanks, Will. A few showers last night, so the odd damp road on the drive-in. Take it easy. Look out for lights on the blink at Torrens Park. It's on Belair Road at Springbank Road. Medindi, damaged barrier, main north road near Knotted Terrace, slowing up the drive-in. And in these parklands, Adelaide 500 is about to kick off this morning, so look out for lots of folk heading into the event, around to Kettleville Terrace and the Britannia Roundabout. Cameras today, Wood Street, Millswood and South Road at Edwardstown. Buy one, get one half price and all footwear at the Rebel Black Friday sale. Hurry though, sale ends Monday. Shop in-store and online. Exclusions apply. Rebel Sport is calling. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Rowie and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show.
From the Tickford Racing Team, James Courtney and Cam Waters, do you love the fact that it is the last race here in Adelaide and the fact that it stacks up really nicely against the other events?
Rowie and Timmy G.
I reckon you guys have the best round of the season. I think for me it's a better race here and it's an awesome event. You guys put on a fantastic event. The best part is that we get to have a drink and enjoy the festivities in Adelaide on Sunday night and then into our gala on the Monday here.
4 p.m. weekdays on 5AA. We understand not all small businesses are the same. That's why Nissan Fleet offers tailored vehicle solutions for your unique business needs. With dedicated fleet managers available across Australia, we're your local fleet experts, providing quality advice, support and customer service for the entire life of your vehicle fleet. Visit your local Nissan dealer or search Nissan Fleet today and we'll find the right business solution for you.
When it's hotter outside than a dead dingo's donger in the desert, inside your air-conditioned Austrac camper, it'll be cooler than a wombat's warren in winter. Haven't heard those before? Yeah, just made them up.
Austrac campers!
Wallace Cinemas is a family-owned South Australian business that prides itself on supporting its community.
Get back into your local Wallace Cinema and see movies like they should be seen on the big screen with magnificent quake sound you can feel.
Bit of quake sound going on here at the moment, so grab a popcorn and a choc top and see all the movies on over the holidays. There's Wonka, Disney's Wish, Next Gola Wins, Aquaman, Trolls Band Together and so much more.
Christmas Cine Savers are back too. You can pick up 5 movie tickets for only $60 on sale until December 24th. They also have gift cards, e-gifts, movie meal deals and great little candy bar stocking stuffers. That's your Christmas shopping all done.
Wallace Cinemas, SA's home of magic and entertainment and Christmas gifts. Mitcham, Mount Barker, Nolunga and the Piccadilly. Wallace.com.au.
5AA's Tech Talk with your host, Adelaide Tech Guy Richard Pascoe. Thanks to Harvey Norman Computers.
Black Friday has become a huge day for savvy shoppers and Harvey Norman has big savings on computers. They've taken up to 30% off all Windows 11 computers, including the Acer Aspire 3. With a huge 15.6-inch full high-definition screen and 13th-gen Intel Core i3 processor, the Acer Aspire 3 is built for work and play. Whether you need a reliable and affordable laptop for the kids or something to keep you connected, organised and entertained, the Acer Aspire 3 offers the best value for money. The computer also includes 16GB of RAM and a 512GB solid-state drive. Get the Acer Aspire 3 at a special Black Friday price of just $597. That's a saving of $400. Save during Black Friday week at Harvey Norman.
Check out this great offer at a Harvey Norman store near you.
Rosanna Mangiarelli here from 7 News. Join me and Will Goodings for Adelaide's leading news hour, 7 News, tonight at 6 o'clock.
Breakfast on 5AA, David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
If you're living with a disability, injury or health condition and looking for work, visit maxima.com.au.
Live from the Adelaide Velo 500, where the red flag is out as we speak. Bit of action on track. One of the Porsche Carreras came unstuck going into corner 10. It's great having... Everyone should get the opportunity to go to a race with Sam Daddo, because you can literally point at a screen and say, where's that? And he'll go, that's the 10th corner.
I don't want to sound like I'm pointing out the obvious, but the reason that gentleman in that car, that very expensive car, is now just sitting there with his... The front of the Porsche is in gravel, the sort of stuff you'd get from, you know, any local good landscaping supplier. So the back of the Porsche is on grass, the wheels are sort of stuck in the grass, the front of the car's in gravel. All of that would have been avoidable if he just slowed down a bit.
I got a good shot inside the car trackside as well. It looks like... I love the steering wheels and vehicles these days. They look like Xbox controllers. All right, let's have a look at the fuel situation. I'd be fascinated to know what fuel costs in one of these Porsche cars ripping around at the moment. Download the free RAA app to find the cheapest fuel in an instant. The cheapest at the moment, the cheapest diesel is $1.92 on Hackney Road. Unleaded-wise, the cheapest in the inner north, $1.71 in Prospect. In the west, it's $1.69 along Henley Beach Road in Torrensville. Let's take some Meat Tray Friday callers, starting in Karakalinga. Adrian, good morning.
Morning, boys. How's it all going down there?
Yeah, good, thanks, Adrian. How's life down in Karakalinga, mate?
Hey, fantastic. God's country, as they say. But, yeah, very lucky. The story I've got, so when I was a young guy, I got my first really good car. You know, I didn't listen to Dad and buy a block of land at Karakalinga. I bought a car instead, which was a really good investment. And there's a bit of tongue-in-cheek there, but... So I got a Series 2 VS Calais, and my mum and dad said, what do you want for Christmas? I said, oh, I'm all good, I don't want anything. What about a personalised number plate for your car? Oh, yeah, that's all right. So I'll have a think about it. So I got back to him and I said, too easy. I want just the number 2 and easy, because that was my sort of attitude, pretty laid back. So they were like, yeah, done. Anyway, my birthday comes around, and I turn up down home, and I'm waiting, and mum's right there, happy. Dad's got the screwdriver ready. I open the wrapping, and it doesn't say too easy. It says easy 2. And it's the old school bright yellow number plate with the green writing. It just stands easy out two. Like dog food. And it says I'm easy 2. And I said to my mum, I said, Mum, that means something completely different. What have you done? And she's like, oh, it was heaps cheaper this way. It was only $150 for the whole purchase. And I'm like, yeah, and I look heaps cheaper as well. Anyway, I kept that number plate because bless me, mum, she's a sweetheart. I put that on my car, and the amount of looks, weird looks I got, but I was a joke of town, and I still kept it on anyway. I just accepted it, and it's still a laugh these days. The boys still take the piss out of me, so...
That's superb. She might have caused you some embarrassment, Adrian, but she may have also won you a meat tray in the process.
Easy too.
We'll find out by 9 o'clock. William in Mansfield Park, good morning.
Good morning, lads. Wish I was with you. Currently, I'm in Riverland for the weekend, but it's an inspiration. I'd love to be there. But moving forward, back in my late 20s, I'm 40 now, so we're talking 15 years ago, I had a Ford Falcon XR8, an AU XR8. And the car was, back in the days, it was lower wheels, suspension, exhaust. It was already standing out without having to get a personalised number plate. And so I thought, you know, being, you know, my early 20s, I'll get the number plate that would represent the car, but it'll be a little bit cheeky. So being an AU Falcon, I got the number plate AU Wet. So I was hoping that I would stand out to all the girls and they would look at me and think, you know, the car's hot, you know, the driver's hot. So it kind of didn't last very long because the number plate received, I think, a negative review, actually. Yeah, so that was my number plate.
I can imagine. Thank you.
I got to say, I barely heard that.
No,
frankly, I'm kind of glad that I didn't.
Yeah, I to anyone each and every Friday call, if we don't laugh at the appropriate time for the next 25 minutes, we'll give you the
don't
reaction.
Don't take it personally.
It's just because we have no idea what you said. I didn't understand anything William said.
No.
But I'm sure it was great or it was terrible.
Yeah.
Whatever you think it should have been.
One of those two scenarios.
That's how we're going to react.
My suspicion is the second.
The car's now significantly quiet because this practice session's coming to an end. So maybe we can squeeze in a couple more metros that we might actually be able to hear. Let's go to Redwood Park. Glenn, good morning.
Good morning, guys. I many years ago, when the personalised number plates come out, my dear friend, who happened to be the local vet in a country town in the southeast, he got his number plate because he had five children, and because he worked 14-hour days, he'd come home and the kids would be all over him, and he'd have a couple of drinks. So he got a number plate for himself, which was kids KIDS 0.08 because kids drove him to drink. And then when his his marriage started going a little bit left of centre, they were still together for about 5 or 6 years. So he got one for her and also at the same time the drink driving dropped from 0.08 to 0.05. So you guessed that he got one for her, which was kids 05, because she and the kids drove him to drink.
One way to solve your domestic dramas, I guess.
Thank you, Glenn. We'll take some more Metro Friday calls after 8:30. Right now, though, we can head down to the paddock, the area behind the pits where all the drivers congregate and the teams are getting ready, and they all knock around over the course of the day, because that's where Sam Daddo is this morning, roaming around, seeing what he can find. Just describe the setting, Sam, for people that aren't familiar with it.
Morning, boys. Yeah, I'm down in the paddock Adelaide 500, as you can see on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream. Plenty of stuff going on here. And luckily, I've done a Martin Brundle and just bundled someone up, so apologies. But South Australian Nick Perkat is along. Nick, what's it like being back in Adelaide, being your home track?
Yeah, it's great. Facility is looking amazing. Obviously, the government listened and promised some new shading and fixed all the grandstand stuff and stuff like that. And I guess the whole facility is just looking pretty special at the moment. So, it's great being back. Obviously, hopefully it's dry, gets a bit more atmosphere here in Adelaide, but can't wait for the racing this weekend, and last one for the year, so normally everyone goes out in style.
So first practice session yesterday, how'd you get on, how are you feeling in this Gen 3 car, first time in Adelaide?
Yeah, it was good. I think Chaz was quickest and I was fifth or sixth, so thereabouts as a team, and looking forward to seeing what today holds. Looks like it could be dry, but you know, we don't qualify until late this afternoon, so anything can happen then. So, yeah, we'll see. Once we get dry laps under our belt around here, we'll see what the Gen 3 car's like.
Appreciate it, Nick. Favourite driver. Thank you, Nick. A South Australian-owned very own Nick Perkat there. And this is the thing with the supercar events that you just don't understand as a footy fan or a soccer fan, is that we are in the midst of the paddock. So you're not going to go to the Adelaide Oval. You're not going to go chat to, I don't know, Travis Boat, Charlie Dixon, all those guys before a footy match. However, we can just roam around here in the paddock. Transport is on my left, garage is on my right, and just mingle with everybody. And this is one of the things that doesn't get spoken about, really, about the accessibility of the drivers, the teams, and just everything. It's a really cool atmosphere. If you can get along this weekend, of course, headlined by Robbie Williams this weekend on Sunday night, Ice House on Saturday night. It's just a cool experience if you've never been before. Yeah, get along if you can.
Great. No, that was good, Sam.
Great work.
And good point.
It was a good indicator of the accessibility. That's not an interview he'd teed up. Sam just wandered down there. And, I mean, obviously a fluke. He chatted with his favourite supercar driver. But Adelaide's own Nick Perkat just was there getting ready for the qualifying a little bit later today. And he went up and said, want to chat? If you did that in the AFL, I guarantee there'd be calls from media managers. People would lose their mind. Who do you think you are?
The AFL's the worst sport in Australia for that.
Yes,
like, you can't
is.
Actually... And the players all get skittish and freaked out. Like, you know, even if you...
It's over-managed.
It's ridiculous. And V8s they put
the
up
best.
One player
V8
a week.
V8 is the best by far.
Yeah, very accessible.
And the drivers, because they all go, we want to promote our sport.
Yeah,
we're happy completely. To do it. They're yeah. fantastic. Good
it's
on you, Dick.
It's a real people's sport.
Well done, Sam. Thank you for that.
All
right.
That'll slow down a bit.
We've got Feedback Friday coming up after 8:30. If you'd like to play and have a chance to win $100 worth of Samtas seafood, you've got to be one of the first three callers through. Get calling right now. 8223 0000. Feedback Friday's coming up when we return.
This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Showers easing in 22 with the 8:30 news. I'm Kendall Brettig.
Complete Windscreen supply and fit front, rear and door glass. Proudly South Australian since 1976.
Three boys have been arrested after crashing a stolen car at Greenhill this morning. Police spotted the Audi speeding on Slape Scully Road. Senior Constable Rebecca Stokes says it stopped at locked gates leading to a quarry before smashing through them and hitting a bollard.
Four youths were seen to run from the car and into the quarry and surrounding bushland. So police quickly set up cordons and brought in police dog Chaos to search the area. They caught three of the youths a short distance away on Willow Bridge Grove at Burnside and arrested them. So far we've been unable to locate that fourth youth.
Checks revealed the car had been stolen during a house break-in at Unley Park on the 22nd of November. The manhunt for wife killer Kevin Jewell has ended after his body was found on the York Peninsula yesterday. A statewide hunt was launched after he shot and killed his estranged wife Jodie at their Modbury North home. Domestic violence campaigners don't want her death to be in vain. A walk for respect will be held tomorrow morning from Victoria Square to King William Street starting at 9:30. The armed wing of Hamas has confirmed the four-day pause in fighting in Gaza will begin at 3:30 this afternoon our time. Four fuel trucks and 200 aid trucks will also be allowed to enter the strip on each of those days. Qatari Foreign Ministry spokesman Dr. Majed Al-Ansari says the criteria on who's to be released is purely humanitarian.
They will be 13 in number, all women and children, and those hostages who are from the same families will be put together within the same patch. Obviously, every day will include a number of civilians as agreed to total 50 within the 4 days.
Australian banks, building societies and credit unions are joining forces to launch a new anti-scam accord. Georgia Kondek explains.
The big four and smaller bank branches are waging war on scammers, investing millions into protective software. $100 million is being dedicated to rolling out a new confirmation of the payee system. The software will ensure customers can confirm they are transferring money to the right person. Customers should expect more warnings or delays when paying someone new.
It's all about the bargains today. Black Friday's arrived and retailers are expecting us to splash the cash. Today and the subsequent days of sales are tipped to result in a $400 million spend in SA. Rundle Mall manager Andrew White says they're catering to everything a shopper needs.
And we're going to have major discounts across all retail categories. A lot of activity. We have one of the more concierge and bag drop service. You can come in, do your shopping, drop your bags, have a drink in the pit stop bar in the Gawler Place canopy and grab a bargain.
And new data shows Aussies aren't buying new underwear. The US owner of bonds has singled out the Australian market as being very difficult, with sales plunging in the past year. A coast-to-coast proposal is being put forward to try to revive the 2026 Commonwealth Games. Victoria abandoned the event earlier this year, blaming spiralling costs. Gold Coast and Perth have shown some interest, although not getting the backing of their state governments. Lord Mayor of Perth, Basil Zempelis, says it'll take a radical approach, but it could work.
If a coast-to-coast Games can A, send a bit of a message that the country is united, but B, get the Games held in Australia as per our commitment, then why not? I appreciate it's different. I appreciate logistically it's unusual and unorthodox, but there's no reason why it can't work.
Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Glider Roll Garage Doors new Platinum and Native Series sectional doors are here. Gliderroll.com.au.
Here's Tom Wren.
Thank you, Kendall. Practice for the Adelaide 500 continues around lunchtime today, with qualifying all set for late this afternoon. Wet and slippery conditions are again expected for drivers. Australian wicketkeeper Josh Inglis insists the players are focused on their T20 series against India just days after their one-day World Cup triumph. Inglis smashed a 47-ball century in a two-wicket loss in the series opener. He says the Indian fans clearly appreciate the extra cricket.
It was a really good atmosphere, wasn't it? I'm not sure if it was sold out, but yeah, it was very loud the whole time, and we always love coming to India and playing cricket here. It's always great.
Let's go to golf. Cameron Smith will need a big effort on day two of the Australian PGA Championship just to avoid the cut after a disappointing start yesterday. He finished at two over, putting him 10 shots off the lead. Lucas Herbert and Mark Leishman are among those who've already teed off this morning, both players currently sitting at three under, five shots off the pace. Well, Serbia is through to the Davis Cup semi-finals following a 2-0 win against Great Britain. They'll now meet Italy, who took care of the Netherlands. Meantime, Australia will face Finland in their semi-final clash tomorrow. And Sam Kerr has bagged a hat-trick to help her Chelsea to a 4-1 win against Paris FC. That was in the European Champions League this morning. And that's the 5AA sport.
Now onto the traffic.
Reimagine your home, elevate your life at 88 O'Connell Street Luxury Apartments. See 88oconnell.com.
At Torrens Park, traffic lights out on Belair Road at Springbank Road. Medindi, damage barrier, Main North Road near Nottage Terrace, speeds at 40. And in East Park, Lands Road closures continue for the Adelaide 500, which has just kicked off this morning. So look out for lots of folk heading around to Kettleville Terrace and Wakefield Road. Got a few cameras today, Anzac Highway, Plimpton and Everard Avenue at Keswick. You drive home after drinking because you don't care if your missus has to drive you around if you get caught, or your mum might have to identify your body. Yeah, you're selfish. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Stay cool. Service your econ at Automasters. And keep cool with Cool Now, Pay Later options.
Showers easing in 22 today, showers tomorrow 20, cloudy on Sunday 21, and the same for Monday 20. At the moment 19. More news as it happens on 5AA.
We have $100 worth of Sam Tass seafood to give away. We're doing it in the next 10 minutes. All we need you to do is answer five simple questions, to which there are no wrong answers. Play along for Feedback Friday. Get calling now on 8223 0000. Three spots available, 8223 0000. Feedback Friday coming up in just a moment.
What's better than Black Friday at Toolkit Depot?
How about eight Black Fridays in a row?
Oh, you're good.
Toolkit Depot's Black Friday sale is on now. From November 24 to 26, buy a Milwaukee M18 Fuel 2-Piece Power Pack and get a bonus angle grinder. Plus, get a bonus battery. Or buy an M18 Fuel 6-Piece Power Pack and get a bonus rotary hammer drill. Plus two bonus batteries. Head in-store or online for more Black Friday deals at Toolkit Depot.
Some builders think a sloping block has limitations. When Beechwood Homes look at a sloping block, they think, ah, the possibilities. Beechwood Homes know how to make the most of a sloping block. In fact, they specialise in them. Beechwood will design a home that works with the land you have, taking full advantage of every square metre. So if you're looking at a sloping block, go for it. Beechwood has your back. Life's good. It's even better in a Beechwood home. Google Beechwood Adelaide.
I'm going to get you to redefine your definition of something. I'm going to get you to redefine where you live and what luxury means. If you didn't think that that was possible, have a look at 88 O'Connell Luxury Apartments. They're two-bedroom, two-bathroom apartments, now selling from $1.2 million. These apartments are redefining the definition of residential luxury with amenities never seen before in Adelaide.
Have a listen to these features: a New York-inspired sky deck, Mikado fresh produce market, wine bar, integrated wellness studio, sauna pools and allied healthcare. For anyone thinking of a fresh start in a beautiful apartment with a choice of peaceful parkland or CBD vibrancy at your door, you must check out 88 O'Connell. If you'd like to learn more, plan a visit to the display suite or inquire at 88oconnell.com.
Breakfast on 5AA. David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
If you're living with a disability, injury or health condition and looking for work, visit maxima.com.au.
21 minutes to 9. The GT World Challenge is going on behind us. For the next 11 minutes, we have a practice session out on the track. We've had the Porsche Carreras just a short time ago. That were going around. So if you can hear them in the background, that's what's happening. In the meantime, it's Feedback Friday. We've got $100 worth of Sam Tass seafood to give away. I think we've got space for one more Feedback Friday caller, actually. So if you want to get on board and potentially win yourself $100 worth of Sam Tass seafood, get calling now on 8223 0000. Apologies to Ben and Les and whoever ultimately is the third person that participates, but if I don't react appropriately, Ben, I'm sorry, mate. I can't hear a damn thing you're saying. Good morning to you.
Morning, boys. Happy Friday.
Yeah, happy Friday indeed. Hey, Ben, the sales are on at the moment. Do you think you're going to be doing some Black Friday shopping?
I thought about it, and then there's far more interesting things I'd like to be doing, but I might get dragged into the city by the missus, but we'll wait and see.
Yeah, I think you won't be alone on that front. Do you think South Australia will ever have toll roads, Ben?
I hope not, no.
Yeah, it was canvassed earlier in the week by us, I think, largely, because of all the road infrastructure that got cut. Ben, do you think the AFL should disclose the salary of the new CEO, Andrew Dillon? Because they don't, of course, make public the CEO's salaries, and they haven't done so for about a decade.
I would love to know how much he's on. I would love to know. Absolutely, yeah.
they're a bit coy about it.
Well, the rest of them get put... The rest of the big wigs get their pay announced.
Yeah, absolutely.
AFL CEO doesn't for some reason. Not sure why they get protected in that way. Are you going to post a Christmas card this year, do you think, Ben?
A what?
Are you going to post a Christmas card at all, do you think?
A what? No, I don't think so. I think getting the kids to do some Christmas cards for the family and close friends and stuff like that. But I haven't received. Yeah. I received a Christmas card probably 2 years ago from a mate in England, and it made my Christmas. It was great, but yeah, that was 2 years ago, and before that, God knows when the last time I got one.
Yeah, no, they've gone the way of the dodo, that's for sure.
And just lastly, Ben, if you could, would you do a hot lap around the street circuit here at Victoria Park?
Well, judging by the sound in the background there, sounds like fun. So I'll just give it a red hot crack.
Yeah, I tell you what, they're really moving these vehicles out there at the moment in the GT World Series. Good on you, Ben. Thank you for that. Let's go to Morphettville. Les, good morning.
Good morning, Will. How are you? And
Les, we've got unfortunate outbreaks of both COVID and gastro around at the moment. When was the last time you wore a face mask, do you reckon?
This morning. I had to have compulsory blood tests end of year, and I wore a face mask waiting in the queue. I was number 5. And got there for 7:30, a 7:30 appointment, and at across the road from the Morphettville Racecourse at the Morphettville Medical Centre. And I err on the side of caution. COVID is out there for the public, so do the right thing and protect yourself at all times.
Yeah, fair enough.
Fair
Les.
Enough, Les.
Good on you. It's a personal choice.
Les, it's a month until Christmas Eve today. Have you started your Christmas shopping yet?
Oh, yes. Last week I got my niece a present. That answer is yes. I have started.
Robbie Williams is the headline act down here at the Velo 500 this weekend. Are you a Robbie Williams fan?
I have a very eclectic taste in music, and yes, I love a lot of Robbie Williams. Also, Harry Connick, big interest in Harry Connick.
He's a good singer, Harry Connick Jr.
Professional Juilliard trained at the Juilliard School of Music. To answer your question, yes, I love a lot of what Robbie Williams...
Well, you clearly know your music, Les, that's for sure.
Absolutely. Hey, Les, Gina Reinhart called on the federal government to reduce petrol excise to make Christmas more affordable for people. Do you think it's a good idea or not?
I think it's a great idea. Absolutely, Dave. Absolutely, Will.
$2.20 a litre, unaffordable for so many people.
Not sure how old you are, Les, and it feels impertinent to ask, but the US President celebrated his 81st birthday this week. Do you think you'll still be working at 81?
Well, I hope not. I hope to be retired in my 60s. And I'm 58. Yeah. I'm a young 58.
Good on you, Les. Thank you, mate.
Cheers, Les.
Let's go to Grange. Mark, good morning. Mark, is your Christmas tree up yet?
Could you repeat that again?
is your Christmas tree up yet, Mark?
No, our theory here is the 1st of December to the end of March, end of January.
Yeah, good solid 2 month period.
Okay, whatever you said, I'm sure it was good. Would you ban schoolies, Mark?
Would I be at schoolies?
Would you ban it?
Oh, look, you know schoolies, you got kids.
You know what I did one time? I told my son, the first time he'd driven his car, and I said to him, you follow me all the way to Victor and slow up, because I was getting in front of him to not to drive fast, because I was a bit scared of those curvy roads at Victor.
Yeah.
Hey, sorry, Mark. Just play along. Do you think the AFL team, your AFL team, Mark, do you think they did well at the AFL draft this week?
The Crows, I think they've done well. I'm waiting for next year. If they don't play the finals, I'll be very sad.
Yeah, that's
the expectation. Well, they should have played the finals this year.
Mark, the commercial radio world celebrated 100 years of existence this week. How long have you been listening to 5AA for?
Do you know something? I started when there was a guy called Greg Sanders, that far back. And 5AA, this is stuck on the dial here. I said to my sons, don't touch that dial or else. So it's always been 5AA.
That's good parenting, Les.
And just there, just the last lady, Adelaide Ice Arena. It's going to be closed for a little while, not for as long as we feared at some points yesterday. Have you ever been ice skating at the Ice Arena?
Boys, you haven't seen me. I'm a pretty big fella. I reckon I might crack the ice. I think I was, no, thank you.
Oh, Mark.
Well, thank you, Mark. Don't. Appreciate it. Thank you for bearing with us. Much more difficult to assess the feedback when you can't hear the feedback. But anyway, yeah, we've got $100 worth of Samtas seafood to give away. The good news is no one should feel personally offended on the basis of how this is awarded, because I'm sure it's going to be totally random today.
I must admit, my focus has been thrown somewhat by the fact that my slightly shambolic arrival here this morning, where I got lost and entered the track.
Don't spoil it yet. Tell us after the break. All right.
The winner is Les.
Les, $100 worth of Samtas seafood coming your way. Now, I know you had to disappear out of the news break for a moment because you received a phone call.
Well, I've now received two phone calls from numbers that I'm not familiar with. It turns out that they are security people.
Okay, there's a lot of people at the moment that don't know why and how your start to the morning was shambolic. We're going to tell them exactly what happened then at 5 to 6 and what's happening right now.
I might need to leave before 9 o'clock.
Let's check traffic, though, thanks to Keezer. Check them out if you've got back pain, kieser.com.au.
At Torrens Park, traffic lights on the blink, Blair Road at Springbank Road. Woodville North, blackout affecting lights on Woodville Road at Torrens Road, also First Avenue. McDindee, damaged barrier, Main North Road at Nottage Terrace. And in East Parklands, Adelaide 500 is kicking off for the moment, so look out for lots of punters heading in around to Kettleville Terrace and the Britannia roundabout. Got a camera too, Wood Street at Millswood. The Black Friday sale is now on at David Jones. Take up to 60% off the supplier's RRP of selected mattresses from Silly Posturepedic. T's and C's apply. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Get saving now with City Discount Tyres. We're offering great deals on the world's top brands in tyres, wheels, suspension and parts. Suitable for four-wheel drives, SUVs and passenger cars, including Falcon, Michelin, Pirelli, Kumho, Hankook and many more. Finance options available. Search citydiscounttyres.com.au and locate your nearest dealer today. City Discount Tyres. We're driven by value. City Discount
Tyres. 5AA's Tech Talk with your host, Adelaide Tech Guy Richard Pascoe, thanks to Harvey Norman Computers.
Black Friday has become a huge day for savvy shoppers, and Harvey Norman has big savings on computers. They've taken up to 30% off all Windows 11 computers, including the Lenovo Yoga Slim and Intel Evo device. Powered by a Core i5 CPU, 16GB of RAM and a super fast 512GB solid-state drive, this computer is perfect for work or schooling needs. The Intel Evo platform gives the computer the ability to have instant wake-up for quick boot-ups and a real-world battery life of 9.5 hours. It also comes with a 14-inch 2K resolution screen for a great image. Get the Lenovo Yoga Slim at the special Black Friday price of just $898. That's a saving of $400. Save during Black Friday week at Harvey Norman.
Check out this great offer at a Harvey Norman store near you.
Now, the best way to see our beautiful country is through the windscreen of your four-wheel drive. But if you want to get there, you want to be TJM equipped.
Their Black Friday special is actually a Black and Yellow Friday special because it's two promotions in one.
That's right, Will. Get 15% off TJM protection products like bull bars, side steps, rear bars, plus 15% off all XGS suspension products.
Get at least 20% off camper gear from swags to awnings to shower tents and 20% off all recovery gear like winches and recovery kits.
I need one of them myself soon. TJM Christmas essentials like beach towels to travel tumblers, cooler bags, all 20% off. They're the ultimate stocking fillers.
If you love 4x4 camping, don't miss TJM's Black and Yellow Friday special. On until Friday, December 1st, chat to TJM's 4x4 experts at TJM in Nailsworth and Clovelly Park.
Mawson Lakes Mazda's 2023 Play Clearance Sale is on now. Discover amazing deals across the entire range, including free on-road costs on all cars. That's right, free on-road costs across the entire Mazda range. Hurry in to find your perfect model and colour. The sooner you get to the showroom, the better your chance of scoring your dream car. Mawson Lakes Mazda, just a short drive from the city, Salisbury Highway.
Breakfast on 5AA, David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
Jobs, apprenticeships, traineeships and careers. Maxima can help. Learn more today at maxima.com.au.
If you love your food, make sure you're listening to Angie McBride today just after 3pm, where Chris Jarman will join her for the 5AA Food and Wine Show. Thanks to Smeg and Pals. If you're building or renovating, your first choice should be visiting the Smeg showroom at Debney Distributors. Taste the difference with Smeg and Pals. Getting into the Adelaide 500 track before 6am to do a radio program requires some coordination. So we had a plan this morning that we were going to arrive in the car park, aim for the walkover bridge over the track, and call Sam Datto, our producer, to tell us where this broadcast will be happening this morning. At 5 to 6, Sam and I are sitting here setting things up. His phone rings. On the other end, it's David. And I see Sam with some exasperation say, "Where are you?" He looks out towards pit straight and exclaims, "Hang on, I can see you." He's playing the video right now on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream. And we rubbed our eyes, but there it was, David's Toyota Kluger going down pit straight looking for the car park. Well, the problem is, there wasn't a lot of time to find the right car park, so you found a car park. That sounds like those chickens are coming home to roost.
Very much so, Will. Now, I am on a very tight schedule here. If there's any way I can leave before 9am, I may well have to do that, because I've parked next to the Golden North ice cream van just on the left-hand side of pit lane. Since 8am, I've had now three different calls from three different numbers that I'm not familiar with, all from security here at the track, saying, because the car park pass on the windscreen of the Kluger has my name and mobile number on it. Now, I had a call just after 8 saying, "Mate, you got to move your car. It's a main thoroughfare," which I didn't know when I parked in the dark before. The second call said, "Your car's about to be towed." So I rang the bloke back, and he was extremely terse. And then in what I think is one of the all-time great wind-ups, the bloke's the head of security, but he's also a big 5AA fan,
no,
and he did it as a total piss take. So,
oh!
However, every many a true word said in jest, at the end of it, he said, "You do have to move it, though, and you've got to move it as soon as you can." So, if you're trying to get a Golden North ice cream at the moment, and there's a Toyota Kluger, I tell you, they shouldn't let me back here.
It's been
a bloody disaster.
I feel like there's a half a chance if we leave you go 5 minutes early, like in some sort of Chevy Chase style moment, I'm going to look out, see the GT series and the Kluger going down pit straight here as you try to navigate your way out of the track.
I think the more likely scenario is that you see a tow truck taking the Kluger down pit straight and just dumping it somewhere outside the course. But yeah, I apologise to everyone for pretty much everything that's happened this morning. The snubbing of the hot lap, the driving on the track, and now the blocking a major thoroughfare next to the Golden North ice cream.
It's been eventful. It's been an eventful day trackside.
It has been a lot of fun.
It's impossible not to have fun when you buy trackside Velo 500. Wherever you park, choose to park your vehicle at the end of the day.
See that? That just happened.
Now, Michael Keelan has been out and about meeting great local businesses for our 5AA 12 Days of Christmas promotion, and today he's chatting with Gavin from Grundy Shoes.
FIVEAA celebrates 12 days of Christmas.
Gavin, tell us about the 155-year history of this fantastic business.
Well, my great-great-great-grandfather started the business here in Rundle Street. We've moved up here to our current location in 1921. We've been trading in Rundle Street now for 155 years, and we've just welcomed our seventh generation into the business.
What other trends have you seen with shoes?
Back in the days, making hobnail boots, workwear, football boots made locally as well from Rossi's, but now to a casual basis. Good quality, comfortable travel lifestyle is certainly the trend at the moment.
Yeah, Gavin, you've got three locations.
Adelaide in Rundle Street, Diddy Road Glenelg, and Ocean Street, Victor Harbour.
Gavin, just getting to Black Friday, what are you offering here at Grundy's?
So this is a very unique offer for us. It's not something that we traditionally have done in the past, but we are offering our customers for one day only, 20% off in-store and online. Come on in, check out our range.
Merry Christmas from 5AA.
And we got a $250 Grundy shoes voucher to give away. They're celebrating 155 years in business. Not too many businesses in town that could lay claim to that sort of it, local history.
I bought some shoes there for Graham Corns' daughter for an article about Ugg boots. And
right.
I bought them at Grundy's, and there was a fashion shoot. It was a story for The Australian, and she posed up behind in front of one of those murals in Rundle Street. But Grundy's, excellent range, excellent store, excellent people.
You can check out their range online at grundyshoes.com.au or indeed their three stores. And today only, because it's Black Friday today, of course, in case you haven't heard, the million and six times it's been mentioned.
How many text messages have you got from
every single place I've ever bought something in town. They're 20% off their entire range as well today.
Amazing.
So that's a great range. Good
Three pairs of shoes.
Great people at Grundy's.
Have a spare just in case you lose one.
Exactly right. Get in and check them out.
They tend not to sell them like that, though, do they?
Sam Daddo, who is
going
in his element here, not just yet, joins us.
So I just got another
at the
call.
Oprah Winfrey style couch.
I just thought I'd mention, because we are down here at the Velo Adelaide 500, the V8 supercars, of course, the main draw card. They hit the track today, 12:35 for practice 2, then 5:35 this afternoon. It'll be qualifying for race 27 when they're going flat out. And you'll be able to listen in, because the drive guys, Rowie and Timmy G, will be broadcasting from here this afternoon whilst qualifying's going on. So it's a big day here at the Velo Adelaide 500.
Well,
certainly
they're
is.
Gonna have, they're going to have a lot of fun a little bit later today. You're just setting in for the day now, are you?
I think the boss is listening, so no.
Okay, you're working really hard all day.
He would be thrilled if you stayed. Sam, you got the passion for it and the knowledge of it, and we'd be buggered without you, frankly.
Who wins the meat tray
of this show? Oh, look, I there were so many great entries. Some of them were putrid, and we apologise for that. There was one we didn't hear.
We got some texts that said it was horrible. But
yeah, we're really sorry if anyone, particularly female listeners, were grossed out by that. We don't endorse that kind of malarkey, and frankly, if we could have heard a single damn word, we probably wouldn't have put it to air. The winner, though, in a much more tasteful and humorous vein, old Too Easy himself, a.k.a. Easy 2, Adrian from Karrakalinga.
His mum buying the license plate for him and getting it wrong. Going the thrifty version. Hey, we're out of time. Stick around for Matt Pantelis. Remember that, as Sam mentioned, the sports show will be your trackside as well from later today. If you're coming along to the race, have a great weekend. We'll catch you Monday morning
from
6.
I've got to go and get my car.
On 5AA mornings today, our road toll continues to climb. Do we need safer cars and age limits on cars on our roads? And domestic violence, called today for a royal commission after the deaths of four women in South Australia over the last week. I'm Matthew Pantelis. Look forward to your company from 9.
You've decided to build? It's exciting stuff. When you've found land, it's a good idea to get advice on what you can build on your new